Fuck.
Now let's throw some crud on it!
Hello. Welcome to Crud Stream. I'm British now. What's going on, my lads?
Pluh.
That sucks. I'm an idiot. Hello, everybody. Welcome to the Crud Stream. We out here on Friday night. Friday afternoon, actually, 4:15 p.m. Let's see what's happening on the seas. DA Crud. Oh, shit. I wasn't supposed to reveal the fit. Fuck! Yeah, what's up, Jess the Cosmonaut? What's up, Rui? Nessie, The Reasoning, Mikey Glazier, Link God, AJ, Kelp, Moronic, Melon, Goldrooted, Freme Lux, Dapper, Purd, Azua, Herbostos, Clowned, Jammy, Frog Thunder, Chaffee. Thought Australia wasn't real. It's, we're working on breaking through. What's good, Crushroom? I don't even know, man. I'm just logging on to site, just seeing what the fuck's going on. We have what? When is the next season? Hang on. Is the next season... It's the end of next month, isn't it? 5 weeks. Alright, hang on. Let's do a little calendar here. So, we've got the next week ends on the 7th, 14th, 21st, 28th, 5th. So, the 5th of May? April 30? Because the PlayStation pre-order like goes live on the 25th, doesn't it? Like, they get the early access. 30th? Oh, okay. Cool. Too long. I mean, it's only 4 weeks, 5 weeks, like, you know. Season 12 looks fire. I do like Season 12. I've done a lot of testing, and I'm very excited about it. Say that much without, you know, breaking any kind of fucking NDA. Yeah. Craig, did you see one of the Hansel twins got married? I don't even know who the Hansel twins are, if I'm being honest. How do you do your Bogan impression? Well, so Goldhoarded, I am from a very rural country town. I don't live there anymore. I moved to the goddamn city. And so I just do an impression of how I would speak when I was growing up and how my entire family speaks. Which is like, oh, here you go, mate. You fucking, you alright, mate? You gonna jump on the cigs later, mate? We're gonna go down to the fucking servo, mate. We're gonna steal some fucking cigs from the fucking guy, mate. We're gonna get fucking blitzed on Winnie Blues, and then we're gonna do some fucking skids in Dad's VL Commodore. What do you think, mate? It's just that. I'm not even acting when I'm doing that. I'm just talking how I would talk if I didn't move. You need that VOD? Which VOD do you need, Dapper? Are you from Queensland? Nah. I'm from Vic. Or from down in fucking Victoria, mate. My birthday gang based. Something Deb's video this morning or yesterday?
Season,
oh yeah, that was...
12 looks fire from the reveal video. Let's hope they can actually deliver without letting new bugs out.
That was the last stream I did like 2 days ago, so yeah, I can send you that. Purd, that's, yeah, so... I mean, my favorite thing to do is bug speculation. What have we got? What are the major features we've got? We've got harpoon walking, so you'll be able to, like, do that and then walk across it. I mean, that could have a myriad of fucking bugs with it, like, just, like, desync and shit like that. We've got throwing knives, which, I mean, hit reg. We've got the double barrel gun, hit reg. We've got... the horn that makes you move. I feel like the horn's going to have desync, because if you're blowing back players and they're running at you at the same time, if the server's not synced properly, it probably won't do anything. Bone caller, I don't really know what bugs could come there. And the scatter shot, I mean, that just looks like shit, if I'm being honest. Doesn't look like it does much. Yeah. If Japan won World War II, you'd be speaking Japanese right now. Yeah, maybe. It's only one of us here in WA. I've only been to Queensland and Victoria. I've only been to two states. You mean Hobart? Yeah, I mean Hobart. Whoops. Did you move to Melbourne? Yeah. It was, like, I had a choice. I was 19. It was either move to Melbourne or start doing fucking, shard, as we call it. And I was like, I don't really want to be a drug addict. So I was like, I'll just move to Melbourne. It was, you know, tough decision, right? Bro, I can't wait to finally board Captain Ship. Can't play my ship after 6 whole years. I mean, that's not even next season. That's the season after that, isn't that? That's season 13. So that's another 3 months. So that's like 5 months away almost. Get hit reg with a throwing knife and you can't even pick it back up. Ugh. Be funny if the bone callers spawned ancient skellies. Dude's three of them. Shard. Yeah, no, that's what we called it. Like, I don't even know what it is. It was ice and then it was shard. And, like, I'm pretty sure that's just meth. But, like, it's not... normal meth, because it's Australian meth. I don't know, I just remember fucking, you just hear everyone, oh, all these fucking toothless bloody shard head over at the fucking Centrelink. What did I say, either? Over at the fucking Centrelink, mate. She's got fucking no teeth left in her head, mate. She's a fucking shard head. Fucked up smoking shard. Speaking of Shart, Minecraft is coming soon. I'm just figuring it out. I think what it might be, I know everyone's giving me a lot of suggestions. I might just do a vanilla playthrough to begin with. To see what it's like. Because you got to remember, I'm not the best at Minecraft. I think I might start out vanilla and see where I go from there. And who knows, if I actually enjoy it, I might do like a fucking thing. I don't want to do another server. Having a server was, nah, having a server was stupid. Vanilla playthrough on Shark. Goals, I'm going to get fucked up and fucking shoot up, and then I'm going to play heroin and play Minecraft. That's going to be my fucking playthrough. That's good. That's good. There's going to be some kind of throw knife duping glitch. I'm pretty sure they'll disappear after being stuck in something for a while. Fuck all those mods. Yeah, I don't, like, I know my main complaint with Minecraft is there's nothing to fucking do in it once you've beaten it. And mods fix that. But it's been so long that I think it'll be okay if I just go in and just fucking vanilla raw dog it and see how it goes. And then based on how I feel, I'll change things. Minecraft is incredibly boring. Personally, I go with Valheim is better craft. Yeah, but the thing is, Minecraft might be boring. But I'm not. Oh, this is... I need to move my fucking phone arm. Making noises. She's pregnant. Hi, Crud. You were funny last night in Theb's video, you bogan. Thank you. Thank you. It's very fun.
Now let's throw some crud on it!
I will say, in that video, I had one suggestion. I said to him, put in the truth slash lie detector thing when they say they're going to do a FODded. And then we ended up putting it like four more times in the video. So that is my idea. Hope that was the funniest part of the video. Breaking Bad in Australia. 48-hour stream sponsored by Shard. Download 20 mods, hope it doesn't break. Vanilla Minecraft isn't boring unless you played a lot already. Yeah, how do you beat Minecraft? Thought it was sandbox. I mean, there's a boss. There's like the Ender Dragon. Crud time, hammer. Thank you, Pinky. It is indeed hammer time. Enjoy building more on Minecraft than actually progressing. Yeah, I enjoy a little bit of both. Hello, Crud. What's up, Swiggy? Does Crud make streams or cream? A little both. Crud's basically carrying Will's channel. I mean, last two videos were mostly just me. I mean, well, the one the other day where we dealt with that fucking idiotic galleon, that was kind of a mixture of both of us. I'll say with that, there's a lot of cut footage from that because I genuinely was very rude to Ant Mist. There's a part you see where it cuts and you can see the text of what I said to him. And it's very funny.
Do a week of vanilla solo Crudcraft. Don't rule out the server just yet, though. There's still potential to do it right if you are happy, too.
That might be a good idea. Might just do multiple. If the guy in the ferry ever watched the video, he's probably seen it. Yeah, there was a part that was cut on the ferry where, when he's like, yeah, I'm in a call with the other guys, mate. They just want to know how you fucking doing it. I was like, man, I said to him, I was like, man, you're one of the stupidest people I've run into in this game. You don't know what the fuck you're talking about. And he's just like, oh, yeah? Oh, my friend says you sound like a virgin. I was like, whoa, dude. Holy shit, dude. And then Theb just goes, nah, this dude fucked your mum. And then I went into detail about his mum.
The goblin just took my meat.
And it was pretty gross.
Pog.
Should a Skyrim playthrough kill every elf? That would be funny. Hey, Alpha Duggo, thank you. Thank you. Loved how the woman obnoxiously sighed after you bored her with the voice. Dude, that is the funniest part in the video. I'm like, oh, hey, he's going, guys. And she's just like, oh. I think, though, if you really, like, I mean, obviously she was annoyed with the voice, but she was actually more concerned that people were boarding her ship. That chick had a real anxiety about people being on her ship, which was funny because, you know. I was on a brew with my guild member. We sunk a Reaper that sank us and swept player on the sloop reported my friend who plays on Xbox for cheating. I mean, look, if they have no fucking proof. I just read that. The babe ship was so... Dude, the babe ship pissed me off because I was so in the character of just being a bogan because I kept saying, like, Lavendal because, you know, that's just the most bogan way to refer to people. And then, like, I was just like, yeah, nah, don't worry. I'm not going to steal anything from you, babe. And I was like, ooh! She didn't even hear it, I noticed, though. Upon watching the video, she doesn't even notice I say babe. Which, thank God, because, like, I said babe for the special people. Have you tried the new Helldiver toys? No, I haven't. I need to do a little bit. I've been logging on to Helldivers just to do the dailies at the moment because I've been too focused on doing Fortnite. But I do need to do a proper game. Proper playthrough of Helldivers soon again, because I know Time Guy's DMing me every second day about it, and I'm like, yeah, hang on, man, though. I do a lot of... Oh, hang on.
Oh, yay, going back to Wheels. He pinged his server this morning, caused some fucking dense docs, one of the players that featured in a video. For someone to think that's okay is fucked up.
Wait, really? I didn't see that. I don't look at Deb server often. Jesus. What a fucking idiot. Jesus Christ. No, I didn't see that, but I'm gonna go look at that later. Jesus Christ. People are fucking... I'm not gonna say that word. People are silly. Step your babe? No, no. He's not female. What's up, Anselm? Serious trust issues and you easily destroyed every alliance chance for it? Yeah. Dude, the alliance is all we have is pretty funny. When Theb was in the crow's nest, he's like, no, you can't break up the alliance, that's all I've got! That was like the funniest thing to me. Bogan sounds like something a fantasy author would call a small goblin-looking creature. Mmm, interesting. Thought, don't worry, I'm not gonna come anywhere, it was terrible. That was straight up just the shittest thing that I said.
Rock and roll McDonald's.
Fit reveal.
Rock and roll McDonald's. Rock and roll McDonald's.
Thank you, Swiggy. Thank you, thank you. Crow was the funniest part of the Theb video. Dude, that's Theb's entire career since I started playing with him. Got hacked at first aid by people with sunken bones. I don't know how someone can hit 200 hour glass levels and not know what a hacker looks like. People really have a misunderstanding of what cheaters are and what they look like. Can I be a babe? No. Why are you a DA lord? This is because last night Feb and I were cooking up. He wants this to be the Johnny Wilkinson fit, but I don't think DA goes with it. For sure you're allowed to say whatever you want on Twitch. Yeah, but I mean, morally I shouldn't call people the R word is what I'm saying. He put a screenshot of someone who got harassed, basically contacted him after a video in the post. Jesus. Twitch is recommending a hot tub girl whose title has colonoscopy cam in it. Ugh. Aren't they cracking down on like Kuma streams? I swear I read something. They're doing that.
Also, insert Cult of the Lamb into the sub goal crud. We are overdue.
That is what the sub goal is. I had a really funny idea. Remember how I said, like, 10 subs H dive, as in people would think it's Hourglass Dive and it's Hell Dive? I was gonna make it say this, 10 subs Sea of, and people think Sea of Thieves, but it's Sea of the Lamb, Cult of the Lamb. It's funny, right? Part of why people are so quick to hack his aid is because the character model is causing people to hold their guns off to the side when they ADS, so it looks like they're hip-firing from 5 meters away. Yeah, it doesn't help that, like, the models in this game are fucking broken. What are we doing today? I'm gonna go do an Ash and Athena or two. So I find out what I feel like doing. We're just hanging out. I didn't stream yesterday, so everyone, a hangout sesh. We're gonna do a Q&A. I'm gonna read your chat and I'm gonna talk. You know, something I never do. You're crowding me in Aussie land for Easter, already seen a few Bogans? Fuck yeah. Are you in rural area or are you just in the city? I'm sure that guy reported my friend was just coping because him and his crewmates' egos were broke when we sank him. Yeah. People don't like being sank. There's a fucking tweet that I want to watch the video of and react on stream, but I mean, I'm already busy. But fuck, dude, I saw an annoying ass video today. Most people here who have Twitter probably already saw it. Just the... Oh, it was just cringe. What are we doing? Ashen Voyage of Legends. Okay, Bogans aren't inherently bad people. Chat, lol, chill. They're not inherently bad, but it's one of those things where, like, it's the same as a redneck, right? Like, low IQ combined with, like, you know, smoke inhalation, education, their peers, they think bad things are good. Didn't take long for me to find that live stream. What live stream, sorry? Pretty excited for the double barrel flintlock and throwing knife. I'm excited for the throwing knife. I really like throwing knife. Like, that's just cool. I need to know what the damage is, how it works, but I really like the throwing knife. Double barrel flintlock I don't give a shit about, if I'm being honest, because I don't use a pistol anyway. It's cool though, but does it kill people in two shots? What's the video about? It's a Sea of Thieves person who's very unhappy. Mini study. Should I just watch it? Yeah, we'll just watch it now. Hang on. It's very short, and I'll react while playing Sword. I'll just quickly play it for everyone. Display capture. One second. Do that. Do that. Minimize that. Yeah, it's gonna be a short and sweet one, but like, it's just one of those ones where, once again, people who play Sword just have a way that they, I don't know, I don't want to be rude, but like, people play the game fucking wrong. I know Mac posted about it. Oh, here we go, yep, found it. Alright, hang on, let me just sort out Sot real quick so I don't fucking sail into an island. I love woke bogans. They say stuff like, I don't mind the gays, everyone has their imperfections, and they want to seem tolerant. No, I know a lot of people like that from where I grew up. Like, they usually go like, oh, I don't mind if they're gay, you know, I just don't want them to, you know, try to fuck me. And it's like, what are you talking about? Grabbing West Virginia, rednecks is stupid. Yeah. They should have the knock gun to Sot. I don't know what that is. Torn between watching Karate or Queso lose his mind. Yeah, it's up to you. Alright, so here's the video. At a 30-minute fight over a skelly fort I dived to yesterday, all they would do is board and set fire to my ship, and then I noticed this.
Right, where am I? Oh my god, he was driving me into the Red Sea! Are you kidding? Really? This isn't freaking Hourglass, man! Like, what the hell? Just bring your shit back.
A few moments later.
That's why I got annoyed. Like, I get really annoyed with PvP fights where I got frustrated because he just wouldn't finish me. Do you know what I mean? Like, I don't mind PvP if you know they're gonna, you know, do what they're gonna do and then sink you. But when they're not gonna finish you, it's just like so pointless. It's so unsatisfying.
Presented without comment. Now, time to comment. Great tweeter here, Maddie. To be clear, you wanted him to take a mermaid and drive his ship over, giving you opportunity to get away rather than just sail you into the Red Sea, a valid strategy. It is a strategy for sure in Hourglass. You can't Red Sea people in Hourglass, unless you're in the corner of the map. In Adventure, the Red Sea is miles away. I was only making the point he could have put holes in me and sunk me faster. Her entire ship is on fire and actively getting holes. You can hear it. And then your ship was literally on fire. You honestly, it's easy to sell you off on fire and let your ship burn and gain holes and risk you running off while they have to merm back and attempt to fight you while you run away. I'd stay down and hold fire. That's true and a fair point. I will agree though, it's annoying as fuck. Yep. God, bro, I hate when pirates pirate in a pirate game. It's even worse, bro, when they only use fire and sails me miles out to the Red Sea rather than use cannons to bee holes in me. Swiggy being way too edgy. I'm not going to read his comments. Swiggy, you kind of... Swiggy, honestly, you gotta slow down with the fucking comments, bro. You gotta be a little careful with this shit, dude. Yeah, just let me fix this up and then we'll talk about that. Okay, so the first mistake she made was being British. Second mistake. Obviously, you know, we see a lot of people who go, I hate when someone boards me and they spawn camp me and rah rah rah. That person was not being spawn camped. They were being camped whilst being set on fire and sailed out. So the person was doing two different things to sink them. And yet she still had a problem with it, which is fair enough. It's annoying. I pent up rage for it. No, I get it, Swiggy. I'm just saying you gotta be careful. Like, don't get your Twitter banned for, you know, abusing someone. I mean, at the end of the day, it's, you know, play the game how you want. Like, don't harass people. Yeah, like, just... This is, it's a problem. There's this weird mindset with Sot players where it's shit like this, where they're like, oh, no, I can't believe they would do this rotten playstyle. And it's like, that person was trying multiple ways to sink you. Just, like, get mad because you're being sank. Yeah, that's fine. But no, oh, I was being sailed out to the Red Sea. It's not Hourglass. It's like, you can't Red Sea someone in Hourglass. You can sail them out of the zone. That's not the Red Sea. That's not the same thing. That takes like 2 seconds in Hourglass. If I'm on your boat, my boat's fucking miles away because of, you know, circumstances. I'm gonna light your boat on fire. You always see it. I board people, I throw fire bombs at their back of their thing. Because it's gonna put holes in you, you're gonna sink. And I might as well, if I'm keeping a camp on you and the fire bombs are taking too long to make a hole, I'm gonna sail you out to the edge. I never have to do that, usually. But I would if I needed to. It's just what you do. Is this Fetch's rest? Yeah, it is. Hey, Walter, are you keen, dude? Fuck off, dude. Yeah, what an annoying fucking video. Like, just, I don't know why she posted that, especially with the 2 hours later, and then it's her complaining that it's not hourglass, and it's just like, yeah, it's not hourglass, so the person's doing what they should be doing to sink you.
Now let's throw some crud on it!
People in a multiplayer sandbox game can play about players doing what they want. I know. And like, the person wasn't doing anything bad. Like, there are bad ways to, you know, camp people and shit. There are genuinely toxic dickhead ways to try to sink someone, but what that person was doing was like, I mean, they were going over the top with the firebombs. Firebombing the entire ship is probably the reason that they actually ended up dying in the end. You only need to firebomb the back. And, like, you know, hold a camp better. But, like, yeah, no. Get mad because you almost sank. Don't go, oh, I can't believe he's trying to sail me out to the Red Sea and he's lit me on fire. And then the annoying thing is, right, every comment is like, that's a valid strategy. And she goes, yeah, haha. And then someone goes, wow, that's annoying. And even though she's admitted that it's a valid strategy, she'll be like, oh, I know how annoying it is. And it's like, you can't. People do this when they have like a Twitter post that gets a lot of comments where like someone will disagree with them and they might be like, yeah, no, you're right, actually. And then someone else will agree with them and they'll immediately go, yeah, no, exactly. And it's just like, I can see both of your tweets. Did they fix the map pullout cannon launch bug? No. Also, Jesus Christ, I've gotten way too many DMs about how to crud launch. You just pull out your map and you mash F when you're midair. That's all you do. And then you can control yourself. Imagine assault weapon where you're really slow, but you have a ship cannon you can fire and load, like a ship cannon but portable. Yeah, like a catapult, like handheld catapult thing would be really cool. It would be overpowered though. You mash F, that's what I was missing. Yeah, and here's the thing, you don't have to mash F, you just need to tap it a little bit. It's weird. The more you try it, once you know that you tap F a few times, the easier it'll get to do. It'll be to do. So we don't have any streamers like that are allergic to PvP. Dude, 90% of fucking SOT streamers are allergic to PvP. It's crazy that there's so few actual. There's like 3 SOT partners in total that do PvP. If I can get banned for spawn camping someone is weird. It is. That seemed like normal PvP and adventure. Yeah, it's exactly what it was, Hannah. Yeah, they start trying to be friends with both sides. No, they do. I hate seeing that. Everyone on fucking Twitter does it. It's so lame.
Not gonna lie, Crud. I'm still a little sticky from taking out that bug hole from yesterday.
Yeah, Perd, you got in that fucking bug hole, dude. That was insane suicide strat. I mean, it closed the bug hole, but at what cost? Does it have to be a map as any quest? Anything you can zoom in on. So journals, maps, these, because you're hitting the zoom button. They just think people can't check other comments. Yeah, I know. It's like, it's this weird thing that I only see on Twitter where someone will, yeah, have both sides of an argument and they'll be like accepting and agreeing. And it's like, no, I can see that you've just said, yeah, you're in the wrong. And now you're saying you're in the right. We got spawn camp by Letor, who's a blue hat and SOT partner on Insider the other day. Did they clip it? It funny. It was funny, dude. It was funny. Lebs is the best middle line of steals, PvP and PvE, such a good streamer. True. Everyone knows, I don't watch SOT streams other than my friends. Because, you know, I'm not going to learn much. I tune in every now and then, but like, you know, there's no one that I actually watch consistently enough to know how they play. I get all my opinions from my chat when they say, this person has a penguin for their avatar and they made a few questionable decisions. PvE is so mind-numbing after a while, I can't imagine doing that all day. Yeah. Like, something that I'll say is insane to me is when you see, certain SOT partners that may or may not be using a certain software to make their, view account be higher, and they're doing PvE with a dead chat. Like, I'm doing PvE right now because I'm also talking to people, I'm not even looking at the game. Doing this shit alone, like, because if I'm playing SOT off stream, I've got the game muted and I'm watching a fucking movie while I'm playing it. Because this game, like, you know, the PvE at least, if someone shows up for PvP, I should unmute it. Shots of PS. So far, no. Oh, Jesus. Have you tried the new guns in Helldivers? I haven't. I gotta get on that shit. What happened with the penguin guy? Yeah, what indeed. Shit, I need food. I fucking had no food this whole time. Gunsack loot is so boring. It depends. I mean, you gotta make fun out of it. Like, you know, the only real stacks I do at the moment are when I'm playing with NZ Goblin and we do, like Athena cookies and stuff like that, because that's fun. There's two penguin guys. Yeah, one is, you know, one's a SWAT partner and one's not. We'll say that much. Costume is entertaining, at least compared to SWAT partners staying silent or PV. Well, that's what I mean. Like, I don't know how they could even fucking stand it. I'd feel like embarrassed if I have a dead chat and I'm doing fucking SWAT PVE. Like, that's, I don't know, that's weird to me. And maybe I just have more active chatters than normal people, but like, yeah, having a dead chat and just like doing like mundane content is just not interesting. How does CRUD launch work? Let me show you. I need to go back to my ship anyway because I need food. When the boner ball comes out next season, I hope someone finds an exploit with it. Also, I thought he lost partner. Nope. Found the guild I'm in through Blurb's Discord. The guild owner I'm friends with is a lord in Blurb's council. Oh, cool. It took me a month to get 100 pieces of voyage loot. Only 90 to go. Voyage loot. Don't you need 1,000? Is that what you mean? Are you excited for Scattershot? No. I am excited. Okay, the only thing I'm excited about Scattershot is it looks like you can kill ghost ships with one shot because it shoots out 4. Alright, CRUD launch once again. Bob Joe Fredry. Have a map of any kind. Any one of these, alright? Equip it before you get in the cannon. Fire yourself out the cannon. And then hit Q to pull your map back out. Oh no, you don't even have to hit Q actually. You'll just have it out when you fire. Look at the map. Tap F a few times. While you're tapping F, you can change your direction. That's all it is. That was a really shit one I just did. And now I'm on one health. But yeah, no, literally just look at a map and tap F. That's all you do. You can mash F as well. And while you're tapping F, you can just completely control your direction. It doesn't matter what your FPS is. F is the zoom, yeah, but if you mash it, it doesn't actually zoom. It lets you dolphin dive, it lets you land on your own crow's nest if you want to. Yeah, that's all you gotta do to CRUD launch. And something I will say that's very funny about CRUD launch is I have seen people who would be mad about ladder launching, you know, funny launching, be like, oh no, I think that's fine, you know. You control yourself completely? Yeah, vacuum ladder, pretty much completely control yourself, pretty much. You can land in your own crow's nest, like, you can shoot in front of your boat, like, shoot yourself out. Yeah, gotta say, kind of annoyed seeing people who say, oh, funny launch is an exploit, being like, oh, well, CRUD launch is actually okay, and the only difference is the literal fucking skill gap of, you know, doing the inputs correctly. Here, I'll try to KMS by landing on my crow's nest. Yeah, make sure you're watching vacuum layer. Honestly, even though Scattershot looks like winner for PvP, I feel like it could be used after already cannon upgrade several holes of tier 3. I don't think it can make tier 3 holes, though. Alright, so check this out. Aim straight up. Get my map ready. The one thing I don't know about CRUD launch is how much you need to mash, because Deb does it a lot less than me. Alright. Fire out, look at the map, mash F, holding S, and then switch to W, and... Oh, I just missed. Damn it. Hang on, we'll try that again. You can also use this to dolphin dive. Yeah, dolphin diving with this surf... Dude, how good is a lone wolf? You just fucking launch. Like, it's a family-friendly, funny launch. Oh, here we go. Oh, I fucked it up. And then, let's say... Okay, well, let's show you the other version of this. Let's say you want to go really far. You just do this. I fucked it up. I almost dolphin dove. It's because I keep fucking hitting Q too many times and putting away the map. Super Slug made fun of me for DPI exploiting, yet I saw him do the CRUD launch. That's fucking hilarious. Please stack stools. Okay. I mean, when you put 2 tier holes in normal cannonballs, you use Scattershot to top them all off instead of having to shoot each one again. Oh, maybe. Maybe like Apex, we need an inhuman amount of fast inputs. Not really. You don't need to be that quick with it. Yeah, I got a little faster then. I don't know. Get Seb to do it. He's better at it than me. But anyway, yeah, that's how you card launch. You just tap F a few times or just mash F. Scattershot can be used when high-waved. I guess that actually, that is a benefit of it because, you know, it does... Because it looks like it arcs so far downwards instantly. Which, I mean, is obviously by design. You go further as the cannon's at a 45-degree angle. That's about 45 degrees. Yeah. You also go really far when your ship's moving with it. Need to go way higher up to Dolphin? Yeah, I thought so. Scattershot gonna be good at one-balling multiple players like grape shots. Can a scattershot one-ball? I keep fucking it up. I mean, you can see the speed difference to as if I'd already done a normal cannon, but yeah. If I launch make you go further out, is for diving downward than dolphin diving? Mostly for dolphin diving. You're really good to knock around bilge and fuck up snipes for hourglass. I mean, how common is scattershot? Did they confirm how common it's going to be? I mean, I know how common it is, but did they confirm it? Chainshot doesn't one ball? No, you're right, it doesn't. I tried inside of it, it's basically like grape shot. I mean, the name was supposed to be grape shot, and they changed it, and I understand why. Because, you know, saying graped them over and over again would unfortunately become a very, you know, unfunny thing. What does F do with the map out? It's a zoom. I don't know if you can do this on controller. F zooms, but if you mash F, it, like, does that. Yeah, I don't even know if you can do this on controller. Has anyone actually tested it? Grape shot is OG name. No, that's what I'm saying. I'm saying it should be called grape shot, but it's obvious in hindsight why they changed it. Whoops, I fucked that up. I forgot to actually... I keep pressing Q. That's my problem. I always press Q. Yeah, I get scattered. You can't on controller, yeah. Someone was testing it before by changing the input as well of the zoom, and it, like, F specifically has to be the input. Which is crazy. What was the OG name of the CRUD launch? There was no OG name. People were just calling it the map thing. And then, to spite Nessie, because I said it's called a CRUD launch, he goes, no, it's not. I go, no, I'm going to make it called the CRUD launch, and now it's being called the CRUD launch. Getting on the seas now to try it? Yeah, you'll be able to figure it out really well, fucking low. Oh, you can on controller? What were the steps again? So you just need to have a map of any kind, shoot out of a cannon, lift up your map, and just mash or tap F a bunch while you're midair. And while you're doing that, you can completely control yourself. Running a video, so I can't start yet. Ah, nice. Hey, Tuna Raid, hell yeah. Big ups, Tuna. How you going, brother? The stock community having the word grape in the game ain't gonna be a smart move. No, that's what I'm saying, Crispy Rice. Like, that's why they would have renamed it, because... I mean, you know... Even people who don't want to be unfunny, like, shortening it to grape-d, like, it's just, no, it's just too risky to use, like, and I die. Oh, didn't die. Oh, I'm on the least amount of health possible. Where am I going, Flintlock? And where's the other thing? Rubies. Is this your daily reminder not to shoot yourself today? Oh, thank you. Fuck, I almost actually just did then before reading that. Exterminating bots for freedom? Hell yeah. Apparently those new weapons are pretty cool. I haven't tried them yet. Playing Dishonored 2 right now. Go to game. I never really fucked with Dishonored, but NZ Goblin loves them. Real shame they're not really doing much with that series anymore. Be back or company. See ya. See ya, Macca. Everyone who quit playing Salt with me, but when the preview for next season came out, he told me to let him know season 12 out because the knives reminded him of Valorant. I'm very excited to see the knife skins. I imagine the Emporium's gonna have one for fucking every set, but here's what I want. All right, my Chinese contract man, you know this guy, ha, classic. This idiot. What a funny bloke. I want this knife. This knife right here. Can I get that knife? Will that be a throwing knife skin? I will pay the money. Obviously, I'll pay the money. I need that knife. That is the cool... Like, obviously, they need to scale it down because it's fucking huge. But I need that knife. Dude, imagine the fucking Chinese contract dagger hits you in the heart and then you're forever bound to the contract. Why would they not have it? Because they love to reskin things anyway. Oh, no, I know exactly. That's what I'm saying. Like, I imagine they're going to just take every Emporium set and... Because, you know, every Emporium set has, you know, full weapon set. So why not add double barrel skin and a throwing knife skin? How do you get the contract emote? You need to be wearing the contract costume. Whoa. Dev trick shot's going to be sick. I'm excited to learn how the damage works for the throwing knife. In an official concept and not in an insider concept. Bound by blood? Yeah. I use the gold hoarder aesthetic heavily. It'd be cool to have a golden emerald throwing knife. Yeah. What'd you say, vacuum lawyer? This is so silly, I died to fall damage on my own ship. It's crazy, dude. Like, it's insane. Like, the crud launching is actually really fucking powerful. What should be blocky like the other Chinese weapons? I mean, I like the Chinese sword. We used to call it the Lego sword. Can you eat, please? Why? I'm fine. Giant shrink. So you told me I'm unbannable because I have so many Emporium skins. Is this true? I mean, if that's true, then I also am unbannable because I have spent too much fucking money on the Emporium. Does uncapping FPS make for a better Goblin launch? No. So the good thing about Goblin launch... The good thing about CRUD launch is that, unlike funny launch, you don't need a good FPS. You can do it at fucking low FPS. Spend the money on Fortnite skins? Yeah, use code CRUDMASTER when you buy Fortnite skins, by the way. May have a slight addiction to stims. Dude, me too. Every time I'm on like 35 stims and everyone else is on like 6. I don't get it. I just pop them as soon as I get hit. Goblins die after they speak their riddle. Some do perish. Some use like, riddle is like... kind of like a death sentence, so they make sure they're important riddles. East. I wasn't actually reading that thing while holding it. I don't want to play Fortnite. That's alright. Does he want to buy Kratos? Nice. Guardians of the Galaxy bundle in the shop now. You gotta keep that goblin in check. You're going wild on the mic. He's a little fucked up. Very insightful goblin riddle and launch. Me and a friend saw the season 12 preview and decided to try the game out for the first time in years. We are forcing ourselves to do Hourglass so we can actually learn PvP. And let me tell you, I've never felt more incompetent in a game. Dude, Padwato. Amazing way to approach the game, first of all. Starting out with Hourglass, like, you can only go, like, down from there. That's really good. But, watch the Massive Sponge Hourglass guides. You need to watch Massive Sponge's Hourglass content. If you want to learn the tricks, the ins and outs, someone link the Massive Sponge playlist because I don't have the command for it. What I'll say about incompetence, right? So I'm incompetent at the game when it comes to Hourglass, but the most important thing is that you have awareness of how things work, because even if you're fighting a strong opponent, or even if you're fighting a stupid opponent who's still getting the better of you, you just need to learn where things are and how things work. Is that this? No, this isn't. You can sword lunge a fucking keg, Skelly. Wait, I saw that. Shout out to Pinky for teaching me that you can indeed sword lunge a skeleton with a keg without blowing it up. Literally, wherever you're pointing when you sword lunge is where the hitbox is. So you sword lunge, you aim at their feet. You can even pick up the keg and defuse it. Sufton was afraid of PvP, got better with Hourglass, and got into Theban crud because of Season 8. Yeah, hell yeah, dude. Like, obviously, you know, I mean, I'm not incompetent. I know how to play, but, you know, if you watch, like, Sponge's content, dude, you will learn a lot about Hourglass ins and outs. But the most important thing for me is learning awareness. What can someone do? Where can someone be? If you do X, what would their reaction be, kind of thing? And you learn that from playing. Three Skull Post Northeast. That's back over there, isn't it? No, it's over here. I'm playing with anyone, or can I just join? I'm just doing a little bit solo right now. I mean, if you join, that's fine, but I'm not going to be in a voice with you because I'm doing a hangout sesh right now. CRUD launch here. How do you CRUD launch? Me and my mate can't figure it out. Pattern. So, when you pull your map out, you need to be mashing F when you're midair, and then you can move. That's the most important thing. Is that you don't have to mash it, but you need to hold up your map and press F a few times, and you can move. That's the key that no one knows. Landed on the crow's nest. Dude, so vacuum layer, advance, okay, advance crud launch tech if you're gonna land on something. When you're midair, eat food before you land. So then you'll still like probably break your legs if you land on a deck, but even if you're full health and your health goes down, if the animation doesn't end before you land, your health will still go up. Your crud launch, I haven't seen it yet. Yeah, I'll go back to my boat. So what's the guy's name for hourglass tips? Sponge something? It's Massive Sponge. Looking up on YouTube and on Twitch. You know, big ups, Sponge Twitch. Yeah. Him and Nessie do insane hourglass stuff, and Sponge has a lot of really good videos on it. That playlist that Dapper linked, that is the Sponge Guide. Well, it's a playlist of Sponge Guides. He's putting out a lot of content on how to just do everything. Helming, cannoning, what to do when you're in a broadside, what to do when your mast is down, what to prioritize, because a lot of people don't know what to prioritize in hourglass. I don't. I just ask people, I go, what do I do? Yeah. And depending on your region, it'll be very different because, you know, where we play, Australia, OCE, is a much smaller region. So we have mostly focused fights where everyone's trying. So you might have an easier time. All right, so crud launching. So what you want to do, get your map, get in a cannon. Let me aim this like this. Share the cannon, look at the map. Tap F or mash F a bit, and then you can control where you land. So you can move around midair. You can also use it to launch out and dolphin dive. If me and I get lost farms like 2-3 AM. Yeah, if you're playing on a big population server, like, yeah, America, you'll have an easier time adjusting. But, like, if you're starting out on OCE, you're gonna get fucked. Oh, almost. Been getting back on solo hourglass. I'm already going the same level, 124 servant, trying to get level 200. Dude, it's... I hate solo hourglass. Solo hourglass is just... Like, I know I always say, oh, I need to be carried, but I'm fine in just a normal duo is fine. But solo, my brain just fucking snaps in half, dude. Oh, boom! There we go. Back on the boat. I need a duo for hourglass. Yeah. I need a duo, but it needs to be the strongest man known to the world. But yeah, so that is the CRUD launch. Doesn't matter your FPS, doesn't matter, I don't know, what you look like. It's just how you do it. Want two-tone bones, but there's no guardians, only servants. Yeah, that's the weird thing. Like, I got most, so I got all my, or most of my servants comms done before same faction. So I kind of got most of the stuff without a problem. Guardians, I still need to do a bit, but it's mostly just 5 more streaks, 17 more streaks. 100 sinks whilst there's a grade 5, and then just sinks miles and miles. But yeah, I got the, two-tone bones before they added same faction matchmaking. Which, I will say, it did take a long time because of the way it was set up. Like, it was a lot of, you know, matchmaking took forever back before then, but I'm glad that, you know, I didn't have to deal with that. The only thing that I have an issue with now, in terms of the future hourglass progression, when I can be bothered fucking doing it, is this shit. Champions sunk as each company. So I need to sink 15 more servants champions as a guardian, and fucking 27 more guardians champions as a servant. I wish it didn't matter which faction you were. I wish it was just sink a champion regardless of which faction you are. How do you get two-tone bones? I don't even remember what two-tone bones is from. It's one of the comms that it's... two-tone bones. What would two-tone bones be behind? I have no idea. I don't even know why I looked at that. I just have no idea. Same faction battle stink. They should just, like... They need to get rid of the cross-faction shit, like, in terms of the commendation progress. How many build dreads commendations do you need to complete? One, or two technically, but one. If I look at my build rats, 60 out of 61 titles, 507 out of 509 commendations. All I need to do is get one shrouded ghost and then build rats finished. Sink 50 boats representing Guardians of Fortune, or I'd be 100. Yeah. Okay, so cannon launch the landing would cause a tsunami strong enough to delete the spot. Damn. You got half the Skelly Curse cosmetics, but a lot of it's really grindy. I don't want to solo Agos. Yeah, no, so some of the only stuff left for me to purchase in this game is, so both gold curses, the Starfish Eye for servants, which you get for sinking 500 guardians, and then so there's pretty good at this. This has some of the Guardian Ghost ship set and clothing, and then Too Many to Count has, I think, the pistol. So I've got like a little bit of items to get related to them, but then I've purchased every other fucking item in the game. But yeah. Also, that comp for taking flags to Reaper's Hideout, like what? That's the weirdest comp, because they keep breaking that and fixing it. Like, if anyone remembers last year's streams when I was doing Hourglass with Feb all the time, remember how, I don't know if you remember, I used to always beg him. I was like, we need to take the flags to Reapers now. And they'd be like, no, we'll do it after one more fight. We're not near Reapers. And then that next fight would always be a cheater. Every time it was time to take the flags, we would get a cheater. It works for now at Outpost. Oh, that's good. What's the Starfish one again? The Starfish one is, as servants, you need to sink 500 guardians. And it puts a little blue starfish over your eye as a skeleton head. It's really nice. That was the old flex back in early was Verdant Bones and Starfish Eye. You got Verdant Bones? Yeah, yeah. I'm only missing two Skelly cosmetics. Golden Curse and, Golden Bones and Starfish Eye. Which, yeah, I just need to get 500 sinks. This is just miles and then just miles, which I don't, you know, those are whatever. But yeah, 500 sinks is the most important one. But I just don't do Hourglass, so. Would have Barnacle Skull or if same faction battles. Well, that's what I mean. If they just made it win 500 battles as servants, win 500 battles as guardians, it would be fine. Like Verdant Bones and Starfish Eye still flex. What was Verdant Bones? I don't even remember how you unlocked that. Because I have it, but what was the unlock? Was none of these. Was it that? No, it couldn't have been that. That's too easy. That's only 50. 50 champion streaks after ritual. Okay. Yeah, so many of these I did so long ago. Like, it's crazy. Ah, here we go. Yeah, in his name. I mean, I still need to do the Athena equivalent of this. Yeah, what's up, Haunting Terror? Dude, we got some orange names in the chat right now. Sorry to say this, but Twitch says you can't show your perfect body on stream anymore. I did see that, yeah. They said no more streaming sitting on a glass chair with your ass with a camera on it. A lot of orange, real. People want Starfish Eyes just to flex, but I want it because I love marine life. Honestly though, it is a really nice cosmetic. Like, it's a bright blue starfish over your eyes and eye patch. It's actually cool. I prefer pink. Pink's good. I'm brown. Womp womp. I mean, brown. The brown's kind of like a dark orange almost. Like, at least on my screen, it looks like it. What's your favorite Skelly Curse cosmetic? Let's have a look. Wait, you could do that? You could do what, sorry? I'm now different. Oh, shit. So I really like Two-Tone Bones, if anyone remembers, the poopy thinkies. This jacket is just nice. Lobster Pot is obviously special mention. These new pants, these are good. The chair thing? Well, you could, not anymore, though. There's a woman called Asian Bunny X on Askham now. Yeah, shout out to Asian Bunny X. Head-wise, I really like the bucket. I will say something that the funniest skelly fit you can do at the moment, in my opinion, is this. So plain skelly, and then just, I don't think the hat mat. In fact, yeah, no, this is the funniest skeleton fit right now. Just a bloke in his pants. Like, this, I don't know why, but to me, this is the funniest fucking look. Especially because the pelvis goes over the pants. Lobster Pot is my favorite skelly cosmetic. I wish there was more like that, where they're just really funny. Although I will say, with Lobster Pot, I can make my skelly get freaky. Check this out. Anyone has a ship named Sloppy Doopy? No. If I'm dead was a person. It's so funny, dude. Alright, check this out. I can make my crab twerk. Look at this. Ooh, see that? It's trying to break out of my back. Isn't that weird? It's weird, right? Skelly V-line. Rose Genetics were one protein away from a femboy. Bro, how do you find that? Dude, I have a fucked up pirate. Like, even if I don't have Skelly Curse on, look, I'll show you. It's not even a Skelly Curse unique thing. My guy just twerks when I do Cannibal Hide. I do it up on this so my booty's in the air. Yeah, if I just do Cannibal Hide, look, watch. You know when you see those videos where it's like, white girl throws it back at Jamaican party on holiday, and it's like this shit? It's that. Thug Shaker? Maybe. You know, he's really trying to, you know, get some movement down there, but he just lacks the, you know, the flexibility. It was really just crud the whole time. Bros in his feels? Yeah, it's because he can't throw it back gangster style. That fucking plants? Definitely capable of some turbulence. Get a little movement going in there. Saw a twitch for a second. Yeah. Yeah, generic robot. I miss generic robots. Wait, go back. I didn't see the twerking. Here, I'll twerk on the beach. Hey, look. Throw it back, white boy. Throw it back. Oh, shit. Shamefully throwing it back in tears. He looking? Yeah, he was having a little peep. I don't blame him. Weird artwork. Bro, my face when I see the white boy throw it back, scrunchy style. Character gets kangaroo pouch when cannibal hiding. Really? Like that? So you clip that, I'm fucking clipping it. Give me this. Oh wait, you can't take this one. Man, fuck you, Burn and Tony. First white boy to ever throw it back. God, Microsoft still says SOC can be complete in like 620 hours. Is this true? No. I mean, technically you can never complete it, but like, I mean, like... I don't even know what 620 hours would be for. Like, Pirate Legend you can do in like 15 hours, like, without trying hard. Yeah, I don't even know. That's just a random fucking number, I think. Fred immediately dance when he hears 2000 Wacko music. I will, indeed. Where'd they even get the number? Yeah, no, that's just a completely random number. Like, there's nothing, like... There's no specific, like, maybe, like... All Tall Tales will take you maybe, like, 50 hours, like, if you're soloing it and not doing anything funny. Like, I don't think there's anything that would... You could ascribe that fucking time to. It's Shark Week? Dude, fix the goddamn sharks in this fucking game. I can't believe they said we fixed them and they did. I can't believe every patch note was a lie from the last thing. That's true, boring the general salt bozo takes 300 hours. I called her babe, we gotta kill him. Dude, it was awkward, dude. I didn't mean to call her babe. Those skelly ships spawn way more than they once did. Well, funnily enough, in the patch notes, they said they reduced the spawns. Fuck that one up. Yeah. Go tell us your secret with the ladies. Just be funny. Literally just be yourself. Unless you're not funny, then don't be yourself. Baffling the sharks keep getting through. It's crazy that, like, that's like the fourth time in the last, like, 12 months they've done that. They didn't fix any of the bugs like they said they did. No, they didn't. Literally, so that's the thing, Hobos. The last patch they did with patch notes, every single patch note is a lie. Every single thing is incorrect in the patch notes. Other than, like, you know, they added this shit to the Emporium. Every single thing they said they fixed, they didn't fix. Freudian slip moment. Maybe. They're blabbing on about Lou while you're panicking in the background about calling her babe was the funniest shit I've seen in a while. Yeah, and the funniest thing is the chick didn't even notice I said it. But I just, I made myself so uncomfortable. Get ladies in here scream and lie a bunch. I mean, yeah, sure. Even C4? I mean, C4 got patched. Shrine didn't, though. Even the Skelly ships drop ammo pouches till it's... You know, like, everything was a lie. It's crazy. Like, I don't even, like... It was like during community, not community, Golden Glory, when they said, oh, we got an emergency patch for maintenance to fix server stability. They didn't fix server stability. They patched out the Wanderer's Secrets Voyage. That's all they did. Like, just be honest. Shrines did not get patched. Probably because they're, like, you know, very low gain type beat. Low gang. Yeah, no, they didn't get patched at all. Since I talked to my friends about my relationships. Fair enough. Remember there's a problem buying ancient coins and it was fixed in hours? Dude, within hours is probably, like, devastating for them. Dude, there's gonna be so much shit in the Emporium next season if they add throwing knife skins for everything and double barrel skins for everything. They count as voyage loot? I don't know because I'd already completed my voyages, but yes, I'd say they would. Remember the last time I went to a shrine? I can! Never again. Literally no reason to ever go to a shrine. They're British, they can't be honest. I mean, that's true. Morning, Crud. Hope you haven't crud-tested today. Thank you. Chinese contract skin still available? Yeah. It's like really late. Like, you have to go really far back. No, it's called Lunar Festival Costume. Which... they might have reduced the price of it. Because they reduced the price of a bunch of shit. But they should ease into different cosmetics, especially the Emporium stuff. No comment. Can't wait for their update video on the next Emporium update. What's up, Biscuit Muncher? Fleet Exploit doesn't get- Fleet Exploit is still in, and I love that it's still in, because it's just fun to do. Like, obviously it's bad for the game, because people can get a billion, jillion dollars and shit, but I just love doing it, because it's really fun. If it's not fun, it's not worth doing. Bro, they did not even give fucking discounts if you have the Reaper Heart stuff already, so it's still 999. That's cool. Uh-oh. Honestly, Hannah? Not uh-oh. Actually, kind of like, ooh. Fleet Exploit's so fun. It's just fun to do. Like, I love doing that. Like, I don't need... like, obviously, I don't need money anymore. I do like getting Athena rep because I need to get 500. But it's just fun. Fleet Exploit? Yeah, yeah, dive to a fleet as a, I don't know, whoever. And get to the boss wave. Also, we have a new position. Instead of parking at I-10, instead of parking here, like we used to, park here, facing this way. If you do, the Skelly-Gelly, the boss, spawns, board him, steal the loot item off him, the 15k one, and then it'll go despawn and it'll respawn next to you, and you just keep doing that, and you get as many of the 15k item as you want. It's real... that is an inappropriate amount of bounce. It's really cool. Speaking of fun, when's the next barrel grinder game releasing? Dude, never. Unfortunately. Shrine's exploits still work the same way they did, just die and respawn. Yeah. Got bounced around. Dude, why did I get bounced so much? This is ridiculous. What's the new spot? So someone was doing it. And it was just way quicker, like way quicker spawns and despawns from the Skelly-Gelly. And also way less getting cannoned by them, apparently. Yeah. I haven't tried that spot, but yeah, the person who told me, they're like, yeah, we do it this way way better. And I was like, all right. I'll give it a shot in the future. Where are we? Are we at... oh, that was Devil's First. When her lights... show me a spot again for Hero Lit. One text. Yeah, yeah, yeah. So it is... so you want to get I-10, but you want to be, like, here, in this corner here, and facing southwest. That is the best spot for it. So bottom left corner of I-10, facing southwest, over the intersecting, like, lines of the different squares. Campfire to the north. Is that up the top? Yeah, it would be. Profess 2024. Honestly, now that I've quit my job, I should probably do, like, what would everyone's opinion be on an uncapped subathon? You're rocking stoned, you ain't going home if you don't. I've rocking stoned a lot. Yes, bet. But do people actually want that, or do they want, I don't know. Supermax Crudfest? Yeah, Crudfest Infinity. You did not quit your job, you took the stupid juice. Nah, I quit my job. I didn't quit my job because I'm getting paid a lot from streaming or anything. I quit my job because I fucking got sick of it. had a mental health breakdown and was like, I don't need this fucking job. Make sure you do it the day after I get paid. Alright, let me know when you get paid. I would watch Cried Not at 1 AM.
Yeah.
Did you actually quit your job? Yeah. Quit on Wednesday. I gave him an ultimatum. I said, let me work from home permanently. And they said no. And I was like, alright, bye. And that's it. What are you doing for work? Quality assurance for a call center. Same thing I've been doing for the last 10 years. I enjoy the work, don't get me wrong. I just wasn't happy with the job I've been doing, like at the place I've been doing it. Only downside is I don't get to work with my mum anymore. Such a thing you joke about though is being, no, I would never joke about quitting my job. Quit from Rare, yeah. Right, I'm home, you should totally check DMs at one point. I already checked the DMs, man. I will, maybe, we'll see. Job search for me was very rough and very long, but I'm finally starting a new place Monday. I don't even know what I'm going to do about searching for a job. I don't even know if I can be bothered. Mary said you like your work because you get to correct grade people all day. No, I do. I like that. I like the work that I do. I just didn't like where I was working. And like the weird things that were happening there. So you body online for $3 a month? I basically do with Twitch. Wait, is this not the... Oh no, it's Campfire. Where was the Campfire? There we go. Maybe try and make this your full-time thing. I mean, look, if I wanted to make this my full-time thing, I would need to average a minimum of 500 subs a month. So there was a... This year in January, if everyone remembers our good friend AFK Peter, who showed up for a brief time and gave everyone a lot of subs, thanks to him, that was the closest I've ever came to being able to actually subsidize a livable wage off of this. That's obviously at my size... like, not possible at this point. At this point, I'm not saying that's something I wouldn't want to do. And I'm not saying I deserve a million more subs, but I'm saying it would require a lot more to be able to actually, you know, do that. So much easier to live off YouTube and also do the thing Theb does with drop farming. I mean, Theb definitely, like, unironically, the drop farming thing made a lot of fucking money. Like, I don't want to do that, though. I think that's a little fucking... That's a bit of a dickhead move, if I'm being honest. But... I mean, I guess if I did get YouTube going, got a little more extra on the side. I don't know. We'll see. AFK Peter's the same with subs. Yeah, no, he's a really cool dude. Like, he's a genuinely interesting dude. Man's got a lot going on. Why can't it be the south? Well, this isn't south, this is north. But south... Wait, I know it's down there. Akrad, how are you? I'm good, how you doing, Cedric? Does it snow a lot in Australia? Nah, it only snows in the top of the mountains. Like... Very real. I've never been to a place where it's snowing. I've been to a place where it has snowed and that's it. YouTube is actually just way better for money. You get pay per view and not sub. Yeah, that is true. I'm just like really not good with editing. But we are working on something. Where did... Ah, oh, he's over there. Unknown loser remains in the north. Wish it snowed. Dude, I do wish it snowed. Like, my sister lives in New York, and it's like, holy shit, I want to go there on Christmas. Unknown looters remains... Somewhere around here. Didn't you do the true-false thing? That's good enough. I mean, I don't edit Theb's videos. I just give him ideas to put in the video, and he puts them in. And I'm also the content of his video. I'm gonna release a SOT TikTok tonight, hell yeah. Living in New York sounds miserable. Oh no, it sounds like shit. But being in like a big city with snow, like, that's the thing living in Australia, you grow up and like, everything, every like Christmas movie and shit you watch is American. And so it's just like, wow, that's fucking cool. But, you know, we don't have that in Australia. So I want to experience that. I hardly watch Theb when Cry's not there. I don't watch Theb when I'm not there. Every time he's like, check out this video I made with Noob, and I'm like, yeah, it's funny, but it's, you know, not ha-ha funny. I like Noob, but like, yeah. Do you have Jesus in Australia? Not anymore. We did for a bit, and then he just disappeared. Never snows where I live in New Zealand. Oh, does it? I didn't even know it snowed in New Zealand. Makes sense. The only reason I wouldn't want to live in New Zealand is because, like, the earthquake risk. Like, that shit is, like, scary to me. Like, the idea that, like, one day your fucking house is just gonna collapse because the ground started moving a little too hot. City traffic plus snow is awful. Yeah, one thing my sister told me, she's like, so in New York, everyone throws their garbage into bags and it's left on the side of the, like, sidewalk next to, like, their apartments and shit. And so when it snows, the garbage then gets covered in snow and people go, oh, look, it's a big snowbank. And they jump in it and then they get, like, stabbed by all the garbage because it's just a, it's just garbage covered snow. Snow covered garbage. Unknown looters remains to the north. See what I do? Yeah, New York is bad. Miami's even dirtier. Oh, true. Isn't Miami like beach? Isn't it like tropical? Oh, geez. Yeah, it's really funny. Dude, every time my sister visits, she has a funny story. She told me she got punched in the face by a homeless dude. And, like, she just kind of laughed at him because she's like, what the fuck is wrong with you? Is this the unknown looter? Nah, I know this guy. Miami is in Florida. Oh, true. So it's a fucking swamp town. You just live in Melbourne, Florida? Hell yeah. I live in Melbourne, Australia. Miami has bath salts. Oh, hell yeah. Now that'd be fun. Let's bought a fake Cuban. Turned out it was just a guy from Miami. Where the fuck is the looter's remains?
Not letting Kurt go hungry.
Thank you, Swiggy. Thank you, thank you. Someone who knows this game, give me an idea of what the fuck the fake looter's remains are. Is it that dead guy? It must be. West by Southwest. Can I even go that way? Not really. So no, it's not this guy, because it'd be right here if it was. Yeah, no. 30 degrees Celsius the other day, didn't snow for 3 days straight. Dude, it's hot as shit today. I opened the front door before and I was like, nah. Oh, wait. I can go even more north. I'm an idiot. Fuck, I'm stupid. I didn't even think there's more to this fucking island. Ow! Fuck off! I didn't even think there's more to this fucking island. There's his loot. Yeah, this. It'll be this. 8 west by southwest. It's here. What is 30 degrees in freedom units? Like close to 90. Hi, babe. Shut up. Don't fucking babe me, dude. Nice chest, buddy. Oh, yeah. Oh, babe. Nice chest. What's this thing? Wait, Crud knows the distance without pacing. Guy's a genius.
I'll come pick you up.
I mean, it's just easy with any of the digs. You just run and then you jump and then usually you're fine.
Never mind, I just got...
Bro really said, I'll come and pick you up and then just fucking detonated. Damn. Bro was too confident with it. Blew up. Yeah, fucking hell, poor guy. Oh yeah, also, speaking of explosion, can someone please, if anyone remembers, can someone find the Theb video where we're at a FOF and an Ashen Lord shows up and I start screaming that it's a demon? Because it's referenced in that video from last night and I was like, fuck, I don't even know what that video would be called. Jesus, that's a keg. Oh, that's right next to us. I'll find that video, don't worry. Hell yeah. Because I was looking through a bunch that I thought it might be, looking for comments, because I remember there was a lot of comments about the demon thing. But I couldn't find any. I'm like, that is a devil, that is a demon! I'm putting it on your head. Keb creature. I can't, like, I don't know what to do about this keg right here. I saw that one. Yeah, no, it is a great video. I don't remember the context of it. I just remember the part where I start going, oh, it's a demon! And I said my youth counselor won't be happy I'm playing this game. Hmm. That stopped the volcano. Southwest. Okay, Creature's visiting on behalf of Explodey Town as a diplomat. Oh, I hope we can make some good relations and progress together as people. Highly collectible piece. Oh yeah, do these even have... Nope, they don't have any unique shit. Detailing is delightful on like 50 other pieces of loot. Alright, so I found this cool crown. Nothing. I pick up this skull and I can say, alas, poor Yorick. Holy shit. Dude, that would hurt, dude. What the fuck? Dude, that's like Chinese torture, putting your feet on that shit. Okay, forgetting those things exist. This is my fourth, fifth, and sixth crown I've ever found. When are we being kicked out of Hobart, crowd? When you finish your commendations. You just gotta get all your, guild comms, like, specifically, these ones, like, all the distinguished comms, all of these you can only get when you're in a 1000 guild, and, these three as well, these five technically, these ones come with it. So just, yeah, these last five, and then all of the distinguished ones. Who's next in Hobart Guild queue? Sponge has a guy, I don't know him personally. But Sponge has some guy that he was like, yeah, this guy, I reckon. What's up, maybe Roach? Is there a good way to farm doubloons? No. What's the point of crowns? They're just something. I got you, I'll DM. Yeah, no, DM, I want that video because I want to watch it again. We out here feeding farm monster mischievous cheese? Con River on the east shore. Oh, that's the one over there. Possible to join the guild to do some accommodations? Yeah. We have a list of people, but yeah. Basically, that's what we're doing, is we're keeping a slot that has... Because obviously, no one can get to a level 1000 guild. Like, it's impossible. We did it, but we are fucked in the head. We are psychopaths. The normal person who doesn't have a dedicated guild of insane people like we do... just won't get to 1000, or they will, but it'll take like a year. So yeah, we do let people join only one at a time though, because we're only keeping one slot open for it, to then yeah, get their commendations done for the level 1000 guild stuff, because that's how you get the full guild ship set, which is a really nice set. Check Facebook DMs. Yeah, let me check. Hi Kyle, hope you're good. Just wondering if you're home on Saturday afternoon for us to come visit you on Easter. It'll be easy in it'll be in the afternoon. Let us know if you're free. All good. If you have plans, we can catch up another time. XX. I'll say sure. See you then. Why do you want me to check that? How did you know my stepmom DM'd me? That's weird. What would it take to become a permanent member? We'd need one of the other permanent members to leave. Because other than that one slot, everyone else has no intention of leaving unless they get over it. North Scarecrow. Dapper is back at... Yo! Wait, it's... North Scarecrow. That'll be... That way. Send kissing emoji? I'm not sending kissing emoji to my stepmom. Kick a no-namer like Nessie? Nah. Documentary is almost done rendering. They made it in the funny. Oh, nice. Yeah, Dapper is cooking up something very funny. Great, I made a poor financial decision. What happened? Okay, so he's coming to eat you. Uh-oh. Yeah, just, you know, just get him to raid me real quick so I get a million fucking followers. That'd be cool. What am I looking for again? Scarecrow. North. You should have me to be guild. I mean, we can put you in there temporarily to finish the commendations. But like I said... Like, who's in the guild right now? I'm pretty sure no one here... Like, I'm pretty sure we're solid. Like, me, Nessie, Eli, Fat Tall Guy, Good Rat, Tim Tam, Kelp, Keith... Lion Lemon, Logical Mac, Nico, Mifu, Sponge, Jay... Question Mark, Question Mitch, Rui, Sirs, Sozo... Budgie Upgrade, Washi, and Pinky... Yeah, none of these... Other than Sozo, obviously. None of these... These are all, like, locked-in members, so... Simply get one of them banned, and then you can join. Is Case play? I don't know. Probably. I haven't spoken to him in a while. I don't really. Half of the people I don't even fucking. Half of them were like Nessie's, like, it's like half and half. Half of them were Nessie, half of them were me. Is this. This isn't a scarecrow, is it? Like, this isn't what the game considers a scarecrow. Come with you to Boganland? Yeah, man. You in the new Theb video was good. Here we go.
The goblin just took my meat.
As a hog skull? That doesn't mean it can't be a scarecrow.
I did
dude.
It 9 months of crud.
Ayo. Thank you, Crow Goblin. We have a baby now. Go somewhere else at the Dapper's Guild. We can all be gilded. Based. Wants to be the hog people. Dude, rip to the hog people, if I'm being honest. They didn't deserve what they got. Quick, get Sponge another 3 ancient skellies. Funnily enough, that because he was yellowbearded and because the yellowbeard was removed, they never removed him from the guild. Like. Because every time Theb's account gets banned, he just gets kicked out of the guild. The other guild, not Hobart. We've never put him in fucking Hobart. What are you grinding now? Just Athena shit. And I'm just mostly just hanging out. So I'm just doing like lazy shit while I chat to people. Why does Theb get banned so often? So he was banned like 4 years ago for stream sniping, toxicity, bunch of other things. Nothing like cheating or anything, just being a dickhead. But being, he was banned for being a 15-year-old little shit. And because it was a red beard, it's a permaban, which means every time he makes an account, aka ban evade, as soon as they find out it's his account, they ban it because he's a banned player. So it's literally just ban for ban evasion, for ban evasion, for ban evasion, like yeah. They don't want him to play the game is basically the short answer. Deb is only 20, he's only 18. He'll be 19 in a couple months, but yeah, he only just turned 18. Wait, who said yo before? Ah, Reaper 10. Yo, man. Thank you for the follow. 4-year-old grudge against them. I mean, it's not even... Well, okay, here's the thing. It wasn't personal to him. It was just, you know, they were banning someone for bad behavior. It is now personal because unfortunately due to his, you know, his large size online... That they are all aware of who he is, and that he makes content, and that he ban evades, and that he's more popular than a lot of the people they pay to be content creators for this game. And then last year he decided to leak insider quickswap removal, so that just made him even less likely to ever get unbanned. But you know, it's his job, so. Have a mustache, does that make me a dapper fellow? Definitely. Whenever he goes live, his account gets sniped. Sometimes, yeah, but it's weird. Like, his most recent one's already gone. Wi-Fi password 93 is gone. He only used that for, like, two sessions. Although, that's probably because Ant Miss probably did fucking report him because he's an idiot. There was a young entrepreneur? Yeah, his words. So weird because he's getting such a following, but Rare don't like him. Yeah, it's crazy, right? Rare or weird like that? Like, I am... Like, I mean, I'm a normal guy. I'm not a freak like that. But, like, my name... Like, you can't say crud in the Rare official Discord or Twitch anymore. Most of the Rare dev team don't respond to me on Twitter anymore. And I'm pretty sure it's because they're like, hey, this guy is friends with that idiot. Like, I'm not bannable, obviously, because I don't do anything bannable. But, you know, their internal British politics of things are interesting, to say the least. Also, yeah, what's up, Sponge? Are you streaming today, Sponge? There was someone before who was like, hey, I just started SOT, and I've decided to start out by learning how to do Hourglass. It's such a, like, I feel so incompetent. And I was like, you need to watch the Sponge Guides, and you need to keep doing Hourglass as a brand new player. Because then you'll become the best player when you have any encounter, if you start with Hourglass. Yeah? Oh, nice. It's like right here, isn't it? That's like here? Our internal politics are interesting, yeah. That's alright, I mean, they're British, so, you know, what can you expect? One thing I'll always find funny about my association with Theb is when I see, like, a SOT person on Twitter has me blocked, and they only have me blocked because of association, and it's just like, my Twitter, I don't want to goon my own horn, but if you don't look at my Twitter, you're missing out on the funniest fucking content on Twitter. Which Twitter is a hellhole. Nothing funny can be posted on Twitter. Unless it's by me. Crud ever gets unbanned, ever gets banned on Super Europe and knocked till they unban you? Based. Let's just say hypothetically all Rare HQ employees are skinwalkers. Well, at least our schools. Sea of Amazing, that one is real too. Sea of Amazing is based. Ashram Reaches, whatever that is, and whatever that is. Oh, that's here. Press there is no reason for comedy. I'm not even joking. It's funny the idea that someone, because like, I mean, even people who really hate Theb, like, he makes evil fucking content. Oh, he's so toxic. It's like, bro, Theb's content is babbling like a fucking baby and doing a voice at people. And then they get pissed off because he's, you know, once the trick is revealed, he's good at the game. Like, you know, sure, he was toxic when he was like 14, but, you know, he's not 14 anymore. Like, people who block him because of that, because they're like, oh, he's evil bastard. I don't want to associate with him. I'm scared. And they're like, oh, Crud's also scary. And it's like, I am a fucking, like, my online persona is a fucking moron. Like, what do you... go look at my last... You know what? I just said twot, first of all. Let's have a look real quick. Let's see what everyone should be scared of on Twitter and should block instantly out of fear that if they associate with this person, people will think they're an evil bastard. What are you doing right now? I'm just doing fucking Ash and Athena's because I'm just having a chat stream where I just talk shit. Let's have a look at this evil stream. So there's me, saying use code CRUDMASTER on Fortnite, which you should do. Take his thingamabob. What a toxic and critical of sot tweet that is. That, I really don't want to see that content. What I have to do is display stuff every time I want to show something. Because I use game capture on stream, not display capture. Because display capture, for some reason, lags my fucking game out. What else have we got? Oh yeah, you know, funny thing. Oh, this man is a wizard of the seas. That's crazy. I would hate to see that on my feed. Oh look, Sponge Helm Guard. Go watch that. Ah, such a negative personality on Twitter. He's really bringing the sock community down. Even the Theb things that I retweet is just... that. All I'm saying, if you're the kind of person... Look at this, me and my dog in a hotel room. Also, God, my shirt is unironed. That's just me and my pet dog. Me, you know, eating chocolate milk and noodles with my chocolate milk reminder. The milk ceremony. All I'm saying is if you have me blocked on Twitter because
Rocky
of...
Rocky Milk and Megarang number one.
Because of the people I associate with, you're a fucking evil coward and you're missing out on peak Twitter. Your stupid fucking retweet Mr. Beast for $5,000 giveaway tweets are going nowhere. Get it. Tap in. Learn how to tweet properly. Follow me. Like, what's happening on Twitter this time? Oh, I was just talking about how people block me because of my association with Theb.
Did you have anything when you died?
Yeah, just a chalice. And they don't know that I'm a goofy little whimsical guy on Twitter. They think I'm this evil, toxic, PvP... just bastard who makes degenerate content. It's like, no, I'm a funny little guy. I'm a goofy little man. If you get cracked on making you invite me, I need one more for guild accommodation. Yeah. Just hit retweet funny things and reply sometimes and give... Yeah. That's why I do think it's really funny. There's like the, you know, like the cool... Well, not the cool, sorry. There's like the... So there's artist Twitter, right? There's sot artist Twitter. And I love all of them. I retweet a lot of their shit. I support them. People like Jason, even like Comrade Relics, people like that. And it's funny because everyone in sot Twitter loves them, even the people who have me blocked. And it's just like, I wonder how they feel when they see that person interacting with me and they're like, oh, he's the poo-poo man. And meanwhile, I'm just like, hey, look, here's an artist. I'm going to retweet their cool art in the hopes that they get more attention, you know? I know what I'm doing right now is saying, hey, I literally donate to charity, so I'm a good person. But all I'm saying is if you have me blocked out of association with Theb, you're a fucking coward. And you're missing out on the best content. Out of Sweeter is the most chill place until someone DMs a commission for free. Yeah. Yeah. Crazy that we can't come all together as a human, as a community of humans who all love the same game. I know, it's crazy. It's just funny when, like, I don't know, this game has such a weird, like, internal politics with the community. And then you've got me, who's, I'm just 32, dude. I don't care about, like, your cringe little drama. Like, I'll make fun of people for having a blue hat. Animal Crossing Twitter was a war zone. I have their blockers will never be crud. See, that's a good reason to have him blocked. Block him, not me. That's all I'm saying. Crud's too busy calling people babe. Is this Johnny Wilkinson? Yeah. This is where Crud's channel needs to get bigger than Thebs so people stop seeing us Thebs friends, start seeing him as Curd Master. Yeah. I mean, look, we're almost at 7k followers. I do want to get to 10k followers, like, in the next couple months if I can. I did a bit of a feet clean out the other night and don't use as much anyway to put dog comment on something. Yeah, man. Thebs gonna be Crud's sidekick like God intended. Ugh. Dude, when you have a spare few hours, I'll tell you about the behind-the-scenes Siege YouTube drama. That shit is intense. I mean, every game would have that, right? Like, every game has... The name is in the community, the people that people like, the people that have, like, a... I don't know, like, they did something wrong, but people still support them, or, like, you know, they were edgy. And it's just really funny that, like... I don't know, people decide on... how they act around people based on little things like that. I just like making number go up.
Buffoon me.
Gotcha. Brent Ever dynamic duo. I know. Dude, that's. I think that's the funniest thing.
You
like,
can really board with Crudlord.
Yeah. Busted. You can land on the crow's nest. I think the funniest thing when people get mad, they're like when you see like Reddit posts where it's just like. Who are your recommended streamers? And someone's like, I like Theb. And then someone's like, no, he's literally toxic. It's like, bro, 90% of Theb's videos at the moment are just me making a fucking stupid voice and a sound effect. Like, it's the most harmless fucking dumb content. We just happen to be self-aware, though, so we make it funny. Is the Sod OCE server just terrifying? Am I that lucky not to run into your kind? Blocks, OCE... is probably one of the smallest still active SOT regions. Like, obviously there's small ones that are inactive, like, I'm sure, like, you know, there's not many... I'm sure there's, like, one, you know, SOT server in Brazil that's very dead. So... you're likely to run into us. But, like, I don't know. Wait, Ashen Reach is... okay, it is updating, we're just taking it forever. But at the same time, I mean, a big thing that we do, I mean, that I do, Theb doesn't really do this, is you gauge the person before you start messing with them to figure out how they'll react. Like, those chicks in that video where, like, as soon as I get like, hey, he's going, and the chick just sighs, I'm like, oh, I know everything I need to know about this person, how to interact with them, how to make them tick, how to do it in a non-toxic way, by the way, how to just be annoying and see how long it takes to break someone. Yo, the boar post. Everyone knows each other on OCA? Yeah, for the most part. Brazil mentioned. God, would you like some pizzas, pepperoni with stuffed crust and garlic on it? Yeah, fuck yeah. Seek the cave of bones. Friend, they were like yin and yang because they was good at the game, but Crud is the funny guy. Exactly. Oh, is this not the cave of bones? Oh, it is. Non-toxic equals how long until you break? Yeah. I've said this before on stream when I was showing like how people tweet is one of the funniest things you can do to someone is just shine a spotlight on them and let them reveal themselves because most people will break under their own like improv is an important thing to me and there's a lot of people who can't handle that and then they break like even with that Ant-Miss dude from that I mean I know I was being really mean to him because he was a genuine idiot but like the amount of times he just contradicted himself and you just let him talk, it's like, what are you talking about? Southeast. Right, when you get annoyed or mad, I know you change. Yeah, a little bit, but, like, I mean, I rarely actually get annoyed or mad. The only time I get annoyed is if I'm doing Hourglass and I'm just in a shit situation, because it's like, god damn it. That's more of a skill issue, though, than anger. That's me disappointed in myself. Mad? I don't think I get mad that often. I mean, I do fake mad, where I'm like, oh, fuck! But, like, You can tell if I, you can tell that I'm faking it. Factin, you're the non-freak part of Theb's community, like you more than him.
The goblin just took my meat.
Sorry. Oh, upgrade.
My meat just spins.
Base. Thank you. Thank you. Is the fact that non-freak part of Theb's community liked you more than him what prompted you to start your own content creation? I mean, I started streaming ironically because it was a sub goal for Theb that I just have a stream. And I was like, sure. And I just kept doing it because it was funny. Is this the mutinous pirate? Six paces west. Be about here if it is. And I still still stream ironically? Yeah.
The goblin just took my meat.
You gotta keep up the irony, man. You just wait till the payoff happens. There's gonna be a big payoff in an amount of time. God damn it. Hey, Perd, thank you as well. Base Minty. Minty also, you better be going to PAX, Minty. For your second beer ever. Southeast. What the fuck is Southeast? Is this the mutinous pirate? That's a pig. That's a mutinous pig. Probably going to sub going nowhere. Yeah, man. Bird is the gifter, real. That was apparently it was last year. Oh, wait, what? Slippery showed me the vids where... when you versus a screaming, barking man. Oh, dude. Actually, yes, no. I know what you're talking about. Yeah. That was me annoyed as shit. I get really annoyed with genuine stupidity. And that was me annoyed as shit. No, I know what you're talking about. That's a really funny... That's a forbidden crud tape. How did you meet Theb, someone asked? I ran into a cheater who... I was playing with a friend who used to do a lot of arena. Like, he wears the blue jacket, but, like, because he's cool. He's not, like, a sweat or a freak. And then we ran into a cheater, one of my first ever cheater encounters. And then the cheater was asking my friend if he knew these certain people from arena. And one of them was Theb. And he's like, yeah, I'll play with Theb a bit. And then he's like, oh, do you know Theb's full name and address of this? And I was like, what the fuck? So I recorded it. And then my friend sent that to Theb. And then Theb joined the Discord call so we could give him the rundown on what we encountered. And then Theb left the Discord. And then we ran into him when he was streaming. And we were doing the fucking British pirate to him. And then we sank him. And he was like, wait, you were the guy from the fucking Discord. And then he rejoined the Discord. And then we did TDMs. And then every time I killed him, I would pull out this Chinese contract in front of the ferry door. And I was like, the only way you can cross this ferry door is if you sign this Chinese contract. And he goes, he DMs me the next day. He goes, hey, can we do that Chinese contract bit on actual people in adventure? And I was like, sure. And that was it. You can follow Travella. Card can't comprehend such complex things as directions.
Because Goblin just took my meat.
I'm distracted. Now that Glugus is here, I just expect him to do everything. Real? Yeah, base. Thank you, Redsparks. Yes, I remember that. Yes, that was funny. Yeah, exactly. You've never said the story like that before? It's pretty flippin' different. I mean, that's the full version. I've told parts of it. Depends how patient I am with telling the story. Like, the short version is, I was playing with a friend who used to know him, ran into a cheater. The cheater told us his docs. My friend DM'd him. He joined the Discord. Then he left the Discord. Then we ran into him on stream and sank him. And then he rejoined the Discord. Then we TDM'd Chinese contract. And he goes, hey, can I do the Chinese contract bit? I remember DMing NZ Goblin. I was like, I think that Theb guy thinks the Chinese contract bit is really funny. And then I made one of the, one of the most historical videos. Where is this? I need you to solve this puzzle because I'm going insane.
Okay.
Happy Feet's fell off. Holy shit. No comment. Actually, hang on. I actually have a comment. No, I'm not gonna make that comment. Don't worry. Don't worry. That's a really bad comment. Don't worry about it. I got 4 ads as soon as you started telling the story. I got 2 ads right as you started explaining. Ah, shit. Rewind the VOD.
No,
make the
meat.
Comments, okay. Hey, Binkle, I remember one time I made the comment and you were like, that's not true. And I was like, I don't know. My crud box next to my Twitch name is Red. It's a great, good day today. Hell yeah. Oh, I need to set up more crud boxes because I think I've only got a 1.5 year crud box ready. I made 2,000 super credits in 2 days. Jesus Christ, Time Guy. Time Guy, I do need to jump on Helldivers. I know you keep asking to play and I'm like, hey, I'm busy. Because I have been busy, I've just been launching into dailies, but we do actually need to play soon, because I need to get my credits up. Because I'm like 70% done on all 3 war bonds. Crud has literally doubled the views of Happy Feet. So isn't he playing Minecraft? I mean, that suits him, right? Like, that would be his type of game to be a streamer. Make a diamond crud box. I think we have a diamond one.
Might have to do some Googling.
Yeah, I genuinely, like, don't know where this is. It's not in this cave, is it? I feel like a fucking moron right now. Munis Pirate Southeast. Ah! Saying it's a game that suits him as well. I mean, hey, he said people are allowed to joke about his situation. What the fuck happened to this guy? Jesus Christ! What is this? What the fuck is this? Is this real? Bro, what the fuck is this? Spider creature, dude! What the fuck is this? I hate this guy! What, did they put this in here to piss me off? What is this? I don't like this. Bro is being boned. What? This fucking, this is terrifying. Don't put this in your game, Rare. This is what's wrong with this game. Flameheart was getting freaky in the cave. Dude, this is the first time I've ever seen this thing and I don't like it. Oh, I'm pissed off about that guy being in the cave. He watched the Fuzzy Bomb tutorial and died on a rock. He fell weird. The freaky devil's roar, my bad guys. Dude, what the I hate that fucking thing. Don't put that in there. I'm gonna fucking raise a support ticket and say remove that. That goes against everything God has taught us. 8th century Christians wandering into pagan Germany. Dude, that is shit. That guy sucks. Make a jade box. Jade is Chinese approved. I mean, isn't a jade just the red one? The most biggest spider ever, the fastest quick swapper in the seas. Is hourglass easier now? Not for me, but yeah. So our category is pretty small.
I haven't grabbed any of the skulls, but...
We must grab them. Jade's green. You're right. We do have one though. We have an emerald one. So our category is pretty small. Good thing we don't need to hit top 10 anymore. Oh yeah, no. Sot is like... It's actually really funny. People might remember, before they started doing the top 10 thing for Community Weekend, I pointed out on stream that Rare considers stream viewers as important as players, because they were talking about it in their, like PowerPoint presentation about how Sea of Thieves will work. And then, like, 2 months later, they're like, we need to hit top 10. And I was like, I told you. Oh, yeah, that sucks, Binkle. I just rendered this entire documentary with no audio.
Ugh.
You know the Devil's Roar storyline is literally tracking down a crew who died horribly. Yeah, isn't it like... You know, it's like Fetcher Farley and... the rest. Yeah, Sot has less viewers than Stardew Valley. Yeah, no, it's crazy. Like, Sot does awfully as a stream. Like... category for what they claim is a popular game... with 31 million players. And every time, I mean, at least when I'm awake during Australian hours, every time I look at it, it's like... 2.4k viewers minimum. And then, like, 4K viewers maximum. And it's like, what the fuck? Like, that's in... Go look at, like, the numbers for, like, I don't know, like, Apex Legends and shit. It's insane.
The happy situation is one of him succumbing to his own greed and ego. It's also very funny that Binkle made a very stout claim that Happy's lie was real. Of course, Binkle's comment no longer exists because of reasons involving TOS. But a good way to close it out is that no partying.
No partying in the happy situations, except for most of us bystanders. I don't know why that cut off. And then still played the gnome. Non-PvP content kind of sucks balls. Yeah. But, you know, for some reason, the Rare devs really don't want to focus on PvP content. So there just becomes nothing to fucking do. Got that fucking Paramore song from that emo video stuck in my head now. Emmy is the worst fucking voice. Hey, that's my e-girlfriend. I think, was that the lore behind the Emmy voice? I think so. Sea Thieves is a niche game. It's not massive game, Rare think it is. No, exactly. I mean, that's why it's good that it's coming to PlayStation. Like, because Xbox, people don't own Xboxes. No one in Japan owns an Xbox. Like, they don't own one. Bring it to Sony. They are. Brain rot in shit post. Brain rot, like, I need to look at it right now because it's an urgent thing, or is it just something funny? Season 12 to 14 look baller. No, they do. They look good. I recently got really mad about my new genness in that I missed the Festival of the Damned that gave some of the coolest makeup in the game, like the skull face and the fire, the fate fire makeup. They need to redo the old events. Not super important. Okay. No one knows how to PvP and study. They either leave or the game. They either leave the game or run for hours. Yeah, no. It's like, that's not even like a joke. It's just like the majority of the player base of Sea of Thieves, at least in OCE, run. That's all they do. So I had to buy a sub because I got to spend some money to get my social SE for next month. Ooh. If you need to drain any more money, let me know. Can you look at it right now? Ah! So I have more players in the servers are stable and have more ships in them. My IRL friends hate the game because they don't want to hop for a server. Yeah. And, like, they have said Xbox One is the reason the servers have to be 6 ships maximum when able. Imagine this game with fucking... not even 10 ships. Imagine this game with 8 ships of any size. Like, oh. Like, I'm in the Raw right now. And I mean, there's reasons people don't come to the Raw. But, like, there's like a 0% chance we're going to encounter anyone here. Running is kind of part of the salt cycle of life. There just needs to be a way to punish runners. Like, there needs to be a way to catch up to them. Like, I know people get really mad at Feb when he funny launches. But how else are you going to catch up to a ship that's just faster than you? There's no way. Like, that fucking galleon the other day, we chased them for fucking an hour and 20 minutes. Like, it is impossible without exploiting to catch up to someone who's running like that. Buy a faster ship, yeah. Let's add the running horn. Yeah, the running horn is fucking silly. They chased a Reaper at a chest of fortune, and the dude dove instead of fighting. I lost that chest. Fucking Christ. Exploiting, you mean cheating? Ugh. Like, there's just no genuine way to beat a runner other than, like, obviously, you know, a third party shows up, or they fuck up, or they give up, or you just funny launch them. You force them into PvP, because there's nothing else you can fucking do. The horn could be used to catch up to them. Yeah, but then you need to have the horn. How do you get the horn? How long does the horn last? I know these answers. I can't answer them, though, because of NDA. But I feel like more people are going to get the horn and just leave it on their ship so they can run. Forward launch cannon. Yep. I mean, that's why we crud launch. You can launch forward with it. Should be able to shoot balls through sails and slow people. Dude, if you could tear people's sails, that'd be lit. I'm gonna die. Front cannons would be so good for runners. They would be. I've just got no food, no health. Game should just go full PvP out of combat tag where your ship explodes if you don't stick the enemy and just run.
In a room.
Beat me. Beat me, Corky Nut. Yes. No point in spending 3 hours running away if you're willing to sacrifice everything you have to lose from escaping. That's the thing. I hate when people run and then we go, why'd you run? Oh. And then we're like, why'd you run? They're like, oh, well, you're going to sink me anyway. It's like, so then why did you run? Just fight. Just turn around and fight. There's... if you already have everything to lose, you have everything to fucking learn. I don't need to cover this point. We've discussed it a million times. But like... Runner mindset is cringe. Don't run. Exactly. Don't run. Don't put yourself in a situation where you would want to run. Run for hours and scuttle when you catch up to them.
Yep.
And they always have cope. They always have cope where it's like, oh, well, guess what? I dropped all the loot off. And it's like, I don't care. I'm just chasing you for the sake of chasing you at this point. I'm here to teach you a lesson. I don't give a shit about your loot. And even when I did care about loot, it's like I still, you know, I want to break your mindset of it's okay to run. It's not gatekeeping. It's just honest, like, you're killing the game. You're doing damage to the game with your behavior. Or is the easy thing to do, so it's what people deviate to? Yeah. No, there's fucking, there's, not gonna name her name, but there's a fucking middle-aged woman who's one of the fucking community managers on the Discord, and she talks about how she's good at outsailing. That is her skill. She goes, my skill is outsailing people. And so everyone's like, so you run. She's like, yes, technically. And it's like, cool. I'm glad you represent the game online. I'm glad your opinion matters more than mine. Ones around the shores of gold. Yeah, like that's just fucking, it's so weak. Like I know, you know, back when treasure had value and shit, people would run because they're like, oh, I need to sell my just the legends before they do. That's whatever. But like that's gone. Like, you know, that's not the game anymore. I play Slot now, I don't care about Ludo's when I fight people. Yeah, I love fighting people. Just don't like Hourglass because of the meta version of fighting people. And that's on me. That's on my skill issues, right, if I'm being honest. That's not, you know, it's not bad. I'm just bad at it. Slot managers sound so odd. They're British. Yo, Sir Night Gamer. How's it going, brother? What am I looking for? Painted tree. Painted flaming tree to the north. Is that
I got the tree.
Oh. Okay. Funny Launch is cheating. Sothead Discord moderator. Yeah, I love how they're like, oh, Funny Launch is cheating and it's bannable. Our ship on fire. They're like, Funny Launch is cheating, it's bannable. And it's like, no, the devs said that it's not. Fuck, I died. You need to get back to ship.
Yeah, I'll go get it.
Reaper Emmy hunting is a shit, it's all good. That's the crazy thing. Like, we get yelled at now for literally Reaper Emissary running into pit, like, hunting emissaries. And people are like, what are you coming after me for? It's like, because you have a flag up and I have a thing that tells me where a ship is that has a flag up. Spawn camping bannable too now. Spawn camping has always been bannable under certain situations. It's bannable. The way they say it on the Discord, they say if your intention was to ruin someone's day. So all you need to do that is you... Oh shit. You set the back of their ship on fire so they get a hole. And you say, I was spawn camping with intention to sink.
The game has gone from having very exclusive and rare loot to, oh, I lost my funny chest. Lemma go dive to get another.
That's what I love now about people that run this season. It's like, everything you have, you can get within less than 10 minutes. Ooh, the roar is ruthless. I'm on reps. Can I sing someone with the intention to ruin their day? yeah, that's fine, I guess. Yeah, Salt Mods are too busy watching the chat 24/7 and deleting opinions that differ from theirs to watch game updates. No, they don't delete opinions. They interrupt and they go, oh, hi, to all the other mods. Why do we need a reason to spawn camp as an open world game? Because it hurts someone's feelings if you kill them repeatedly and the game tells them to scuttle and they choose not to. Literally telling someone just scuttle and spawn camping them is allegedly bannable, which is insane. The game tells them to do it. They should do it. They already know they're in a losing situation. You know, I have fun trying to break out of spawn camps and then when I'm done with it, if I'm not going to win, I just go, yeah, whatever, and I just give up. That's fine. People are too stubborn and it's my fault? Yes. That is correct. It is your fault. Have these nerds should play back in 2018 when loot took you 1 hour for 10 chests. Yeah, when a captain's chest was like the best thing you could find. What's up, Zero Skill Dad? Got a streamer for Spunk Steam. Nah, he's a good streamer. From level 81 in Reapers, any advice what I should do to level up quick? I mean, just sink people. Like, just win. Oh wait, Reapers. Sorry, I thought you meant Hourglass servants. If you want to level up quick in Reapers... I mean, yes, Hourglass is the fastest thing, but you can just do the fleet exploit and take the loot to Reapers. You're next to Reapers when you do it as well, which is nice. God, don't you love the cartoon pirate game aimed at teens that has half their main source events done on Twitter?
Volcanoes yep. Last way too long.
I think they can last for up to literally 10 minutes.
So stupid.
This game got way too easy in terms of... No, it definitely did. Like, this game is, like, stupidly easy to get anything done now. I cried, hope you're doing good. I'm good. How are you rolling? Broken big galleons and PvP, but almost sinks to Volcano. Yep. Many such cases. Cursed chest exploit. Pretty sure they got patched. It works in different spots. I've only heard that it got patched, but I haven't really looked into it. I was just told it. I mean, I have no reason to ever do Cursed Chest again, unless I'm doing it as Reaper. So like, I just haven't bothered. Ow! Ow! Right, I want to love this game, but the open crew on NA server is awful. Either full of 8-year-olds with no mute button or an AFK crew that slowly leaves. That's my experience with open crew, is just everyone joins and then leaves. Like, people use open crew to try to find a ship that already has $1 million worth of loot so they can sell it without putting in effort. Volcano is funny launching those boulders. It's crud launching them. Why can't I pick this out? Max out 75 by sinking ships, and now the max rank 100. Or was it 65? It was 75. Just want all the cosmetics and sight. Yeah, same. Fleet exploit like hero loot because the other fleet loot exploit was patched. Yes. Yeah, hero loot exploit. Open crew kids are built wrong. Open crew kids are sick in the head. White canopy. Southeast, 6 paces. If you didn't see later, 6 man, see you, Roland. Have fun. I'd find a crew to actually play the game with, but everyone's so damn weird on this. Yeah, the best way at the moment to find a crew is by running into, like, someone on Hourglass that you have good fights with. That also wants to play adventure, though, so I don't know, that's weird. It's a really good session with open crew galleons. I've never had a successful open crew venture. It's always just, like, people who just want to join an open crew that already has treasure, and then they leave because we don't already have treasure. Tons of fucking gems on group posts. Dude, that fucking screenshot where the guy's like, no PC, no... Oh, what does he say? He's like, no UK players or some shit. I don't know, it's funny. A gladiator enters an arena brandishing a sword, but throws the sword down and refuses to fight. They're still in an arena that they willingly entered. The other gladiators aren't obligated to leave peacefully. Yeah, I mean, that's sot, right? That's literally the game. You chose to show up to the game that has the PvP elements. It's not my fault you don't want to take part in them. If you don't want to, you can go play safe overseas. If you do not want to be bothered by other ships, you can opt out of other ships being in the game with you. And sure, you know, people will tease you, but that's because you don't want to play the game. See you later, DB Pooper. No UK players kind of base though. It's pretty funny. It's like not 420 friendly, no UK players, no PC players looking for chill crew. And it's like, what the fuck? But I want to make money. Well, risk it. I mean, that's the thing. That's the dumbest thing about this fucking game. People are like, oh, I want to make money, but let's get sunk. It's like, the fuck's happening to you? Are you hanging out in like just the Ancient Isles all session, and then when a ship comes, you go out of your way to get sank? Like, yeah, fucking hard it is to just run into another boat and like get sank by them. Like, servers, I mean, obviously I'm talking from OCE, which is deader than everywhere else, but like, servers are fucking dead usually. Like, you're fine. Like, we had a Reaper 5 on the server before, he didn't even come over here. Just play to have fun. Exactly. Play to have fun, or do what I do and play to make the numbers go to the maximum number. Participate in the Athena event, but never gave me glass rapier. Yeah, they're fixing that. They said 72 hours, you'll get it. Higher seas are more fun. I tucked in the ship for an hour. Dude, I miss tucking. Tucking was cool back in the day. It was so fun. I did nothing but open crew for 8 months straight and lost too many brain cells. Jesus. What's up, King Sus? Big chillin'. Hope a lot of PS5 players do Hourglass, so I could get easy wins. Yeah, the PS5 version comes out on, like, the 25th, or the pre-order beta access. They really should release a, like, literal, like, here's what Sea of Thieves is! Like, they need to make an intro to the game and make it a video so PS5 players know what the fuck they're getting into. Because the amount of posts of people who are like, yeah, I got on the game, I don't know what the fuck to do. How do I buy a crate? How do I buy a ship? Where did my ship go when I crashed it? Like, the game needs, a proper intro. And I know there's the maiden voyage, but the maiden voyage is dog shit. The maiden voyage teaches you nothing other than you need to fully rep your mast on all 3 holes before you raise it. Well, before you lower it. It's insane how people need an objective in order to play it. Yeah. Sandbox game. That's what, when people, a lot of people's criticism of this game, you know, they'll be like, oh, well, there's no actual progression. It's just cosmetics. And it's like, yeah, because, you know, this game shouldn't, if this game had actual progression, then it would become incredibly unfair, which I wouldn't actually have a problem with. I mean, there should be, like, something else you can decorate, though. What's up, Wal? No, we do not need Rare to make an intro video. No, we do, because it'd be really fucking bad. Try talking today and they'll probably dive. Yeah. Or they'll just sell their one bit of loot instantly anyway, so they won't have a big enough hoard worth tucking on. I'm in this game for the first time years ago. I had no idea what to do. Yeah, same. We just sailed around. It was fun. Cosmetic sucks. Yeah, they do need some other kind of progression. Just anything. Literally add even higher seas where there is progression that gives you cannons on the front of your boat and higher damage weapons. Make a fucking RPG mode of the game where it's like pure sweat. Has higher FOV. Man, I want to be a fucking young kid again. Wow, that almost read the wrong way. But they released Save the Seas because of the game coming to PS5. Yeah, no, Save the Seas is good as a intro to the game. That's why it's stupid that it came out 5 years into the game. It should have been at the start. But the thing is, because of it coming so late, you've now got the wrong audience of people going from High Seas to Safer Seas and then being like, why can't I get more gold? Why do I only get 30% of the gold? And so it's because the game isn't for you. It's for the new players. It's for when dad wants to play SOT with his, like, fucking 7-year-old kid and doesn't want his kid to get, you know, too overwhelmed by other players. It's not for fucking Tamas, who has like 10,000 hours of the game. It's for fucking little Johnny and his dad. Just gotta recognize the Sea of Amazing on any hourglass. Oh, hell yeah, dude. Based. And bought a new cosmetic in like months. I buy them all, so. So badly do I want a lair slash cove where you can see your ship with your gold pile up and you can buy friends. You know, the game needs hideouts. Like, the game just needs a hideout. Add a hideout so you can decorate. Add way more trinkets than what we have on the boat. Let you display commendations in some kind of way, like titles, banners, like. Give people a way to flex other than just their boat's appearance. Safer Seas isn't the PvE server they want. It's a tutorial made in Voyage Fail to be. Exactly. That's literally it. It's not a PvE server. It's practice for new players. Based on my Gilded Shield. Yeah. People, so that was the funny thing. When guilds got announced, everyone was like, oh, they're going to add guild hideouts, I've heard. And, you know, me, who had been on Insider, you know, was just like, no, they're not. As someone made a video, like, heavily implying they were adding them. They're like, Sea Dog's Tavern is going to be replaced with a guild hideout. And it's like, what the fuck are you talking about? Check map for Reaper at Royal Crest. Okay. Nothing. That is. Is that? Ah, oh, fuck me. I'm moving the boat. I'm not dealing with another fucking volcano.
Playing Volcano Simulator.
Yeah, I'm just moving while you stay alive. Are there any actual places you enter is completely separate from the other parts of the map? Yeah, no, it should be like that. Like, the way, like, the Pirate Legend hideout, there's that big waterfall and shit, and it's like, yeah, let me sail into there. I prefer that to people speculating exactly what's on inside is. Well, I mean, that's just Falcor. I mean, it's 6 years for my ship to burst out of Legend Side out like Ray Promise. Yeah, no, that, yeah, exactly.
How much do you care about all items?
I mean, we can just leave them all in one spot and pick them up later.
Yeah, I was gonna say, I could just push the stuff.
Yeah. There's a really funny Reddit post I saw, and I was supposed to tweet today, with a screenshot of just the waterfall and Athena's hideout. Someone did a Reddit post like, was there always water behind the waterfall? And it was just so funny, because everyone's just like, yes, this was supposed to be a place where your ship can be taken off from. And the new Flameheart's hideout and the new ship 10 cannons, be like, yeah, I'm excited about the Burning Blade. That is a really cool feature. Probably be good at fighting humans, but he shits his pants when Mother Nature does anything. Well, it's just because volcanoes are just straight up unfair. Like, look at that. That was aimbotting, dude. Give me a place where people can opt into and it's just a bunch of people chilling in a hideout or something. Like, apart from how toxic the arena pregame was. It was fucking awesome talking to 20 people once. You know, they need that. They need a place where you can just gamble, but you're not allowed to gamble. You're not allowed to add gambling to the game because it'll raise the rating of the game. Just add a fucking little tavern where people can hang out. Tom goes, right, I want to be able to take over Skelly Fort's guild to store treasure and have a PvP game where other guilds can TP to the fort and try to steal for themselves. That's what, everyone thought Sea Forts were going to be like that, because that's how they kind of advertise them. People were like, oh, so once you take over the Sea Fort, once you beat it, you can park there and you can protect it and you can, like, other people will come to you and try to fire you and steal the loot. And it's like, no, that never happened. No one cared. Play Liar's Dice? Yeah, you can play games that aren't quite gambling. Season 13 will be greater than the first competitive voyage. Bro, fuck this thing. Get this off my fucking ship. I'm sick of it. FK'd it for 5 hours and not spot another pirate?
Yep.
It solves so many issues people need a crew. Yeah, no, if you could just talk to people, you could easily find a crew. The loot is dog shit? Yeah, no, the loot is fucking garbage. The Seafort loot is dog shit. There's no, okay, what about this? Secure a fort mode, you secure a sea fort, and then the longer you have it, the higher the value goes up. And then you have to defend it. You know? And it's marked on the map, like, remember that, sea fort event? Big beams coming out, Scott? It's like that, it's marked on the map. And you gotta protect it, and the longer you protect it, the more value you get, and it's just so simple. What are you doing, Crud? We're just fucking around. Open crew is a slot machine. What even is that dagger in the paper on the post? That is white woman jump scare.
Thank you for accepting this most adventurous of expeditions. I'm searching for a specific skull.
That's why
I've asked multiple crews Rip. To embark on this voyage. Just be aware that once you have the chest key or skull, you'll be visible to all the other crews. You might have to fight them off to claim the reward for yourself. As soon as you bring the skull of Siren Song to the destination I give you, I will make my presence known. So what are you waiting for? On with the quest.
Siren Skull, what's that? Nothing is what that is. It's nothing. Garbage attempt at fun that failed. Sorry, what did Time Guy say? I'm saying you should get a personal fort. You can upgrade in different cannons, its own pocket server, but you can activate it for raids and get gold upgraded. That'd be great. Literally add fucking Clash of Clans. Literally add Clash of Clans to Sea of Thieves. Warn me next time, I'm sorry. Help. Fortnite ad based. Make sure you don't bait Briggsy. God's sought hold potential. Yeah, no, Time Guy, you're right. Like, just give us... The way they describe the Burning Blade is the way things should be in the future, where it's like, oh, hey, there's a world event, you beat it, and then you become the world event, and you can get higher value from it. Do that with sea forts. Let me take over the sea fort, upgrade it. Dude, imagine actually having a sea fort with your own personal ghost ship circling it, and, like, yeah, better cannons that fire, like, scattershot than normal cannons, like, just three at once. Capture the flag. Yep. Literally capture the flag. That's what this game is fucking capture the flag. And they didn't, Are you gonna need any Fortnite bases in the future? I'm falling asleep early hours. Kelp, I really want to grind out a lot of Save the World. I want to get to the next area and also get a lot of Battle Pass XP. So yes, I want to play a lot of Save the World. I want to see a monster or let us summon a sea beast to help attract a ship. There just needs to be something. When we're getting ads, I accidentally click a Theb stream. Oh yeah, I turned ads on, but there's only supposed to be one ad every, like, 30 minutes or so. Not even that, no, it's like, it's 1 minute of ads every 30 minutes. I don't know. Nessie did it, so I'm allowed to do it. Save the World is so much fun to play with you. I hate Save the World. It pisses me off, because half of it is doing a mission, the other half is waiting 20 minutes. Give me a time I get prestige and speed up. Yeah, hell yeah. Yeah, I just want to really grind out, get to the next area. Also, all of my weapons are out of ammo and I have no good weapons left. So we know how the fight with the Burning Blade World event, because they didn't talk about the video. What they said was... It'll be a world event. You go up to it, you fight it, you sink it, and then you can choose to pledge yourself to it, and then you get to control it. Give you some 130s. Ooh. I want my, I've ran out of energy cells and rockets. I want my, what's it called? What's that fucking thing that I've got? I want my vacuum launcher back, because I don't have them, and I want my, the thing that shoots a huge energy ball that just rips shit apart. I want that, but it broke. I need a new sword as well. Everything's broken in my Save the World. It sucks. I'm not overpowered anymore. Plasmatic discharger. I need my plasmatic discharger, my vacuum tube launcher, and whatever that cool sword was Kelp gave me. Crud guy literally using me as Fortnite save. Hey, you offered many times. You said, hey man, just let me know anytime you need weapons and I can just help you out, okay? I use rockets and that shit you can have on my base. And lie down, watch those hourglass guides. Been real. Have a good night. Hell yeah, Jess the Cosmonaut. And before you go, Jess the Cosmonaut, I'm gonna shout him out again. He's live now. Right there, Massive Sponge. Oh, I can't fucking shout him out. He's live right now. Go follow him as well, because all he does is Hourglass content, and it'll teach you a lot. Imagine Terminator crew taking over the big boat. That'd be fucking funny, because then they just, what, you get like a flamethrower as well, and extra people on the boat? Will do, bro. Don't miss out on at least following Sponge, so you can see his shit in the future. Cause, yeah, you'll learn a lot. Along with the Burning Blade, we should be able to take over normal scale ships by killing the captains out, sinking them so solo players can go around Skelly crew and Naval against duos. Yeah, I mean, it wouldn't hurt. Wouldn't be bad. Like, there's no downside to that. Is this even this island? It's not. Yeah, no. The game needs more sandbox elements. I don't know where the skulls are. Sponge's gotta be the only legit Gold Curse player. I know a few. Nessie is, Jay is, you know, there's quite a few. Estuary. There is a lot of semi to non-legitimate fucking Gold Curses though, because of the fucking exploit they used to be in. Which is funny, because as much as I like to, you know, do the sillies, I wouldn't have even done that. Because I'm not going to get myself a thing that says I've done a lot of PvP for free. But the devs are going to give you good thrashing for criticizing the game. We were talking about SOT Twitter. That's a big problem with SOT Twitter, is people take all criticism as negative, and then their response every time, the game update's literally free? And it's funny, because it's like, well, first of all, I would happily pay for an expansion. Second of all, it's a live service game. The updates are supposed to be free. They're also supposed to be good. They're also supposed to keep me buying things in the Emporium by wanting to play the game. And when you add bad content, I don't want to play the game. So then your live service model is failing. That's not like a unique thing. If you don't like the game, why are you playing it? That is the most Reddit fucking cope question. I hate that. You don't have to play it if you don't like it. It's like, you're a fucking idiot. That's like... Man, I can't get this shit. That's like the most, like, defeatist fucking cuckold response you can say about something. Live servers never felt more dead. Yep. Cried your mother. Kill us! Would you ever consider playing a game like Halo 3? Yeah, I like Halo. Halo's cool. I've never actually played through the story of Halo. I've only played, like, most of Halo 1 and that's it. And then a bunch of Halo Infinite multiplayer, and then that unfortunately died. But then you had Harpoon Gun. Dude, if I had a Harpoon Gun... Dude, Harpoon Gun is gonna change a lot of how this game works, and I love it. Too bad that's literally the furthest away thing that they announced. I like parts of the game, but it needs more to even be considered a good game. Dude, until the game has 6 ships on the server again, it's just not a good game. Hell yeah. Like, until they fix that, you can't even consider this a good game, because at the moment... There's 5 ships on the server. Garbage. Put more ships on the server. It honestly needs more 6. They said they literally can't because of Xbox One. Which is fucked up. Also, Rare could even recycle content in a better way. Dude, Rare have heaps of content they could recycle that they're not even recycling. Recycle all the old events. Fuck it. You know, the game's coming out to PlayStation. It's a brand new beginning. Redo every event that you've ever done. There's only 5 ships. 5 ships or 14 players, whichever comes first. So at most you're only ever going to see 2 galleons on one server, no more. And that's because the servers break for Xbox One when there's more than 5 ships currently. Drop off Xbox One, it's awful. Yep. Tired of massive starter because of a galleon. I mean, that's the theme of that fucking video with Theb the other day, is they didn't understand that there's stutter on a fucking galleon, and they kept saying Theb's teleport lag, and like, oh, your frame wasn't lagging. It's like, I was. Ah. So you should watch Sozo Edit. No, I'm not. Yeah, I'm busy though, Sozo. I'll watch it when I'm not busy, silly. I know you've asked me to watch it. I've got your DM open on my other screen, but, you know, it's not pertinent right now that I watch it. I'll watch it at the end of stream, so then, you know, I can put full focus on it. Reason we're gonna suck because they're Everwild, but when they come back for the update videos, they take all the credit. Yeah, no, exactly. Like, it's like, oh, look at what we've done. It's like, you haven't even done that. Bro, I didn't realize you saw DM. No, I said that before. I said that like the third time you asked. I said, yeah, I saw it. Xbox One came out a decade ago, so I'm gonna get rid of it. It's almost 12 years old. Just fuck it off. Microsoft dropped 360 after like 7 years. Yeah. Also, Hunter's Call has potential to be its own faction with max level of 500. I swear they said they're not touching Hunter's Call this year either. I swear they said that. I mean, we know that actually, because we know what the next 3 seasons are, and that's covering us all the way through to December. Hate that Drew guy in the update videos. Yeah, I hate all guys named Drew. Hey, time guy. Yeah, no, that guy's weird. His tattoos suck. So sick of diving and my harpoon breaking. Yeah, that is, it's crazy to me that they said they fixed that and they didn't. I'm the Crudcraft sub goal. Oh, I got met. I just haven't started Crudcraft yet. I've been busy this week quitting my job, so. I'm gonna put my galleon in the Xbox One's USB port. That's a really good idea. Maybe Harpoon Gun ties into Hunter's Call. I mean, that could be a thing, yeah. That could be really interesting if it's like Hunter's Call. Hunter's Call commendations, like, get you the skins for it because it's a harpoon. That would, you know what? That is actually really cool. That could be a thing. I doubt it, but it could. Let me harpoon a shark on land. Maybe harpoon gun ties into the sex update. Maybe. Mega surfing. I just think the only thing about the harpoon gun is because they showed it off in such an unfinished state, I feel like it's not going to be as powerful as they showed it off because it's a little too broken. Like, it looks way too good. But I'm very excited. Like, I really want it. Sneak your boss and salt and don't want to work for bad players? Exactly. Hey, great, how's it going? It's good, Quantum. How are you? God, I need Ramsey so bad. Harpoon gun onto Meg's back and just get yeeted under the sea. That'd be really funny if the harpoon wasn't instant for pulling. So, like, you could get dragged. Hammers. I don't know. Hammers kind of suck. Oh, they have that suction thing on the front of them. Want to get wrecked with the harpoon gun? I mean, it has ammo, so there is a chance. That's another thing about it being, when I say it was like, it's overpowered looking. Like, the range on it, the speed on it, all of the harpoon gun's functions look a little too good. That's like, wait, is that literally... Oh, okay. When we get in Flameheart... All I'm gonna say, Natalie, is they did not show Flameheart in the trailer for the Flameheart update. All I'm saying is I didn't see him on that ship in the render they showed. Think of worse? Fair red X's or white X's. I like the red ones. I don't know why people are so keen on the red one, on the white ones. People are like, oh, the white, the high contrast ones. The red's classic. Nothing bad about the red X's. Add hunting spots so you can spear things for Hunter's Call. That'll be... Was there? That would be cool. Spear fishing. And your crossbows and the ability to take the scope off the Eye of Reach like a marksman weapon. More combat updates would be nice. Don't make it ammo-based. I needed to traverse Daggertooth Outpost every single time I log in. Dude, how about this? What's the game I'm thinking of? Oh, why can't I think of the game? Grappling hook, but you can hang off of it. So you grapple right, but it stays stuck in, and you can... Like a Batman grappling gun. Literally a Batman grappling gun. What about that? So not only can you use it to pull yourself in, but you can use it to hang. And then you can second hand a different weapon. Dude, imagine I'm hanging down that rock. I'm hanging off that rock there and I'm shooting you with a fucking sniper in the other hand. Spider-Man PS4 Part 2. Yeah. Hang on to a Meg's back. Yeah, like if it had like physics like that, it'd be so fucking cool. Gotta go to the toilet. Goose is in charge.
Boogie. I don't know, Zero, the disco rave might be a bit dangerous. Are you sure?
I've returned. Alright. I love feet. What? I love fent. What are you talking about? Why are you talking about feet and fent? Yeah, being able to hang off of the,
things are about to go down.
Oh, God. Hanging off of, like, a harpoon would be cool, like a rope. What sort of fish do you think tastes the best? I don't care, because I'm allergic to fish. We need a cooking overhaul? I mean, cooking is really basic in this game, hey? It's just literally throw it on and wait 2 minutes. Gonna make sword combat look more like Mortal or For Honor. They just can't. There's just like, they will never be able to make the sword combat any more than just mashing different combos of ingredients for different effects. Am I fucking stupid? Wait. Am I fucking? Hang on, I am. Sword inside is melee and dark tide, dude. I mean, Darktide has a really good melee thing. Pull out a shovel, hit him with it. Shovel's not good, fold the top of it, and then hit him with that. Make a 4-honor combat system. So I don't know what the 4-honor combat system is. Is that like stancing? Or like, what is it? Parry, maybe? Parry, honestly, with the... So remember how they made it so you have to do a 3-hit? So they changed sword recently where... if you block someone, you have to block all three. You get hit priority. Whoever gets the first hit in gets hit priority for a 3-hit combo. They should add a parry into that. That'd be really good. Imagine blocking and then stabbing with it. That'd be sick. Stamina bar for sword swings? Nah, fuck that. Fuck that. Fuck stamina. Stamina is a dog shit concept. Frontal combat has stances and joystick blocking. Ah, okay. Problems make sword brainless because they combine a Souls-like combo with a Super Smash Bros. Hit stun. Ah, yeah. So that's great sword and plate armor's weapon. Dude, we need a Zweihander in sort stat. Zweihander. Refused to use sword on principle after they removed all skill from it. I mean, that's why I use sword, right? Like, people get bamboozled by it because it's just too good. It's shit, and it's good. Chainsword inside. Only for sword swing, so I can't be swung on a trillion times. Should remove hit stun from the sword, except for the third hit in the combo, but also knocks the opponent back, so it encourages the hitter to pursue instead of just continuing to spam left click. I want to fuck around with the, so daggers you can stab with. Like, you can do a quick stab, a slow backstab, or a throw. I want to know how quick can I rapid stab? Like, how British can I get with the dagger? Can I, like, cha-cha-cha-cha-cha-cha? Because, like, what if that's faster than using the sword to kill someone? I really want to know the damage values. I legitimately haven't been able to test the damage values because no one else has the insider that I play with. Are they adding whippersnippers in sword? They should do that. Do you play Darktide? I used to. Kind of got over it. Gaffy plays a lot. My housemate plays a lot. He's been playing with Gaffy recently. but me personally, no, I don't. I can't be bothered with Darktide. I don't know. Just tires me out playing it. Darktide went hard. Yeah, no, I did think Darktide's great. I prefer Vermintide to Darktide though. Just
Reaper one. In Narnia.
Yeah. Who cares? They ain't coming here. Whippets inside. I mean, there are Whippets. The dogs though, not the fun Whippets. Darktide was fun, but I got burnt out. Yeah, no, I'm the same. Like, I played Darktide the week leading up to release, and then the game came out, and all they did was add one new map and added the cash shop. And there was all these glaring issues they left in. And it was just painful. And then I just got kind of burnt out on it. Like, I know they've made the game a lot better now. Like, I have played it since, but I don't care to, like, main it as a game. You have Insider? Oh, do you pick? I didn't even know you had Insider. Are you Fortnite PvE session this weekend, by the way, but not on Saturday for me, Sunday for you? Yeah. Should be able to purposefully unequip one of our weapons, just fight with our fists, and they would do no damage or range, would be the funniest thing. Dude, honestly, you should be able to, like, that should be, if you're double gunning and you're running out of ammo, you should be able to use your fists, and they do, like, say, 10 damage per punch. Like, make it the most awful fucking combat, but at least you can do, like, a, you know, come at me, pull your fists up, boy. Like, have, like, a little, you know, fisticuffs. Lurking, don't min, aight. Game has so much potential, it's just ridiculously broken, lacks flavor. Yeah. That's my main criticism of the game, is everything is done half-assed. It's untapped potential. They almost have a good idea, and then they don't roll with it. Where's the west? Like, I shit on the game a lot, because I'm passionate. I want the game to be better. Quad boarding with fists would be so fun. Dude, imagine... Like, yeah, quad boarding, no weapons, but yeah, it's just four people just, like, fucking spamming punches. It would be so funny. Like, imagine Gus is fucking the Gus pirate, like, just smacking at you.
Plo.
Make fist combat bad but funny. Yeah, no, make it fucking hilarious. Someone say Insider. Yeah, we're all leaking NDA. Fishman, West. Overwatch 2 tonight? Yeah, hell yeah, King, let's jump on him. Fuck that. MF hit the plur and disappear. Oh, I didn't even mean to hit plur, because I was typing a question mark. Fucking streamer graphics scam in my Twitter DMs. Dude, the fucking amount of, like, DMs you get from scammers. It's so funny. Watch an adventure in the West Pool. Well, I'm already West. Wait, what do I need to do for him? Read the map. So I just don't play much, if not at all. Yeah. I just wanna... All I wanna know is just the exact damage values for the new weapons, because... Every time I play it, I don't run into people. I just hang out and just buy all the items in the shop. Just to pass the hour. Watch Skibbity. You watch all of Skibbity Toilet at 300 subs? Maybe. Only one way to find out. Northeast Campfire. That's what I do. Yeah, no, that's literally all I do on Insider, is I just buy everything. I mean, sometimes I check out the new content, but, you know. If it's, like, weapons, I can test that at the outpost. We're back in 7 minutes. Don't end stream. Things that serve no functional purpose make the game very funny, the best flavor. No, exactly. That's like, that's what the game needs more of. That's why, yeah, fisticuffs would be a funny update. Need God mode on Insider. The game just needs to add friendly fire as an option that you can opt into. A campfire. I'm fucking blind. I'm not even reading this properly. I'm just looking at chat every time I hold up the map and I don't know what it says. Yeah, no, I wish there was just an opt-in to friendly fire button. South by southeast, 9 paces. This is in the northeast campfire. I just did a Falcor.
Plug!
Is this northeast campfire? Hmm. It is! So what I liked about the Windcaller horn was funny, goofy stuff to it. I mean, it's very funny how you can launch yourself around with it. Whoa, loot. Hey, Crud, I posted some of my art on the Discord since I last brought it up. You should totally check it out when you get time. Yeah, we'll do. I always look at the art channel. One of my fave channels. They're so stressed about perfecting the game, getting approval from all sides, that they've unironically lost the spirit of the company, which is to branch out and try new things. I don't even know what their goal is at the moment with SOT. I mean, actually, no, I do. Their goal is to bring in new players. That's what their goal has clearly been since Season 9, is to bring in new players and nothing else. That's, yep. Wait. Yep, that's back there. Oh, wait, but he has stuff. Kogosek, go check channel SKUWU and tell me that ain't peak game capture size. Alright, this better not be some Kuma shit. SK. Cool. How many Ashen Thieves you got? We're about to have our fifth. Don't ever tell me to do that again. Can't even see the game, like, why do it? I can give you a reason why. You can- I can give you two big reasons why. Jesus Christ, dude. The goal is to bring in
one
new
more skull here.
Alright. The goal is to bring in new players at the cost of dedicated community. No, it literally is though. Like, Season 9 was make the world events easier. Season 10 was make building a community easier, which they failed. Season 11 was, you know, extend the gameplay loop. Safer Seas is part of Season 10 also was bring in new players. Or bring old players back. Like, the whole... The moment, I'm pretty sure, Rare's focus is just trying to inflate the player base as much as possible. It's also why they're trying to get... You know, why their Twitch drop thing is, like, get the stream to the top 10. Because they want more people watching the game, more people playing. They don't care about retaining their audience currently. Like, the only retaining their audience feature so far is next season adding new weapons. Because people want a combat refresher. But they're more probably doing that, so there's less focus on the double gun meta. Because removing double gunning, that's part of making it more accessible for new players or just, you know, lower skill players. Yeah, they're very heavily focused on accessibility for new players and not keeping me interested. Your cannon's gonna be crazy. What, you mean the scattershot, Siggy? Scattershot, I mean, didn't they say it only gives tier ones though? That's what I'm concerned about. Like, they seem hard to aim. Like, they have a really, really, what would you say, big drop-off? Like, they have a huge drop-off, like, you fire them and they just go... And they only give, like, tier 1, so that's, like... I don't know, I mean, obviously it needs to be in the game and we can test it, but, like, I don't know when I would prefer to use that over just a normal cannon. Maybe if I'm fighting a brig and I want to, like, try to hit them all. Grapeshot looks useful. Well, that's the thing, it's just, like, it kind of... It's the same thing with the weapons. I'm concerned that they're not going to have an effect where they're even usable. Like, Bone Caller definitely has a use because it's, like, a new mechanic. But Grape Shot... It'd be good if you get close against galleys or came off cannons. Yeah, but Siggy, if I'm close to a galley... if I'm close to a galley, I'm sunk, dude. If I'm in a broad with a galley, it's over. I only play, like, Sloop, maybe Brig. Like... like, obviously, galley probably is the focus, right? Like, because with a grape shot or scatter shot, you'll be able to hit the top and the bottom decks. You'll be able to open a lot of holes, which is an important thing on a galley. Obviously, firebomb, grape shot might be a good play, but, like, I just worry that it's going to be useless filler, and that's what I don't like, because then it's like, oh, man. Who knows? They might modify them. But the drop-off just seems so in fucking insane. Like, it is... The most flaccid firing cannonballs. Like the only time you use them when you're at the verge of winning or losing? Yeah, kind of. Like the fact that they only give tier 1s, I mean that's what they said. I don't know if they can go beyond tier 1. Why have such a hard drop off? It's like, well, okay, all they're gonna do is give a lot of holes, but they're only gonna be low tier holes. That's fine. You don't need them to drop off like that. I can know people in Hourglass while boarding with the Bone Caller. No, so that's the thing. That's why I'm excited about Bone Caller, because Bone Caller adds a brand new mechanic to the game, which is like, is the helm and the cannon gonna have to have different weapons on them to deal with? Who's gonna be responsible for dealing with the bone caller skeletons? Where do they spawn when they're thrown into ship? Do they spawn at top deck and bottom deck? New season's gonna be the nerf of soul. That's what a lot of people are saying. Which I get. If I board you and bone call you, you've got what, four? You got me and three skeletons on your ship. Which me on your ship is already a problem because of my sword. The bone caller is the thing I'm the most excited about. That and throwing knives, but I need to know the throwing knives damage. I need to know how many throws I can kill you with. Because once again, why would I not just use a blunder and a sword? Go for Hourglass Streaks is a necromancer. Also, did they say you can block throwing knives? I don't know if they said that. That'd be really funny. Someone throws a knife and you're like, "Bonk," and it just drops. And then you pick it up, you throw it back, and it kills them. Morning Crud. Yeah, what's up, Necrorulers? Haven't seen you in a while. How you going? What is good? Dude, these are so fun to do. Other than the volcano thing. Man's red dev tier. Man. Still mad I couldn't get it done because of Q's. Oh, yeah, you didn't get your 1,000, did you? Requires me feeling like I need to finish Gold Bones even after 80 levels of the anniversaries and matchmaking. Yeah. Gonna sponge. We have to get Ruby's Fall. We haven't had to get Ruby's Fall in ages. Flintlock. Should we just re-roll this one? Since it's taking us all to other places. Yeah, let's just do it. It was rude that it did that. Not that. That's the wrong thing. Keep fucking going legendary search. Man.
Outro.
I guess we just have to go north. Damn.
Wah.
How are we doing, Crab? I'm good. How you doing, main plank? What's up? How do you do this glitch with cannon and quest? You just need to have your map out. Get in your cannon. Shoot out. Look at your map. Mash F. And then you can change your direction. Also, I've heard. Important thing is that you're holding your map up when you're in the cannon and you tap F a bunch. You want to sail on brig? Nah. I'm chilling, dude. From 866 to 935. So annoying. Spent 3 hours and got 6 games. Jesus. Last white boy eats stuffed crust pizza. Don't look at the sky tomorrow. Possible on console? Allegedly. It's whatever the zoom button is. I don't know what the zoom button is on console, because obviously I don't play with the controller. But apparently it is, because it's not tied to FPS or anything. It's just purely, you just do F. The funniest thing you can do with it... Oh, not the funniest. It's actually really cool shit you can do with it. But you can do this. Oh, damn it. Almost did it. Almost did it. Oh, well. You can land in your crow's nest. Cool. That's so good. You can use it to dolphin dive as well, which is fun. You confirm it works on console? Hell yeah. Taught a lot of open crews how to CRUD launch. Yeah, man. It's a good launch. How do you do it? Shoot out of a cannon. Hold up a map. Mash the zoom button when you're midair. While you're doing that, you can use WAST to change direction. So you can use it to board your own crow's nest, which is useless. You can also use it to dolphin dive. I'm really shit with a dolphin dive, but I'll try to do it. Since we're sailing, I'll try to do it. Crunch, yeah. Looks silly, it's amazing. Dude, no, it's good. It's genuinely good, and anyone can do it, unlike Funny Launch. Basically, anytime you shoot out of a cannon, you just want... Oh, I fucked that up. Oh, no. Oh, I'm zooming, though. Why am I so laggy? All right, well, I got really laggy then, but yeah, you can zoom through the fucking seas with it. Yeah. Important thing is you mash the zoom. Oh, you don't. I don't know if you mash it or you tap it a few times. Seb does it a little differently to me. Oh, there we go. Big one. So if you watched Seb's video, not his last night video, but the day before, where we're fighting the galleon, he does one and he dolphin dives onto their deck right next to their anchor, and it's fucking beautiful. Nessie did it on stream the other day as well. It's really fun. It's just goofy tech. And yeah, it's not tied to FPS or anything, so just do it. How you have movement right left? Using WASD. So get in, shoot out, look at your cannon, mash F, and then you can just use WASD to turn. You can literally use it to shoot behind your own boat or in front of it. It's just a, yeah, really fucking silly launch. The deck shot there goes and say, yeah, no, like, I get when the dude was like, oh, you teleported? Should you use stream loots as your next sub goal? I've thought about doing stream loots, but I need, from what Nessie's told me, you kind of need to set it up. It's like TF2 air strafing. Yeah, it is more of a strafe. Like, I should have called it the crud strafe, but it's too late. Oh, I fucked it up. I always do that. I hit Q instead of fucking E and I put it away. Hello, crud. Hey, what's up, Maxwell Slay? Look, there he goes. Even just doing it, it just gets you further than you would normally go from a cannon, which is good. That's why now every Theb video, you'll see him pull out a map whenever he cannons. It's not complicated. Yeah, no, it's not. I just always fucking up because I just press the wrong buttons. And now I know the question's going to arise. Can you do it in Hourglass? Yes, but you need a voyage. How do I get a voyage in Hourglass? Well, if you cannon out to an island and bury an item, then you get a map. What's up, Shrek West? Wait. Shrek Westmo Bamboo, that is a name. Yeah. Oh, these rocks fuck me up. We did it, we saved the world. Yeah. I'm saying Shrek Wes on YouTube comments like a robot every bit. That's based, honestly. Keep up the good work. I love the YouTube commenters. There's some funny YouTube commenters. Jesus, he got far with his. And thank you, Mainplank, for the gift sub. You legend. It's meant to sound like Shrek West Mobile. I thought it was supposed to be Shrek West, but I was like, what? What? Fortnite Sorbity Toilet? That sucks, Kelp. Where is my mermaid? Oh, there it is. Any members of Crud Armada, I'm saying Sailing Sloop, join if you want. Base, Sir Knight. Is Crud Armada full at the moment? I think it is. No one's been on it recently, I've noticed. Yeah, what's the Chronicles looking like? Okay, some people have been on it, I'm just fucking stupid. Why do I already have a spot? Hang on. Oh no, what was... Shit, that might be banned again on the account he just made last night. Oh no, I didn't invite him yet. Okay, that's fine. That scared me for a second. I was like, oh jeez. We're having a bit of a helm moment here because I was so distracted. Coming in again, Dragon's Dogma 2 looks funny. Yeah, I want to get it, it's just too expensive. Everyone just look away for a minute.
Rocks.
Yeah, look, we're sailing out of the fucking Red Sea as well. I didn't even know what we were doing. I was just busy launching. Distracted driving kills. It does, dude. Almost killed me. Why is... No, it's not. God, that dungeon we did fucking sucked. Dude, Fortnite dungeons are stupid. It was like A vampire? We're gonna watch the PSAs? Yeah. Truman asks Tom, but describe launch, have a tutorial somewhere on YouTube. There's no YouTube tutorial, but this is literally all you need to know. Have a map, shoot out of the cannon, when you're out of the cannon, look at your map, mash F. And then you can use WAST while you're mashing F, so you can move around. That's literally the entire thing, is you just bring out a map and you mash F. That's the entirety of the guide. And while you're mashing F, you can use WASD to change your direction. Wait, you and Theb sunk a galleon? Don't know what you're talking about. Yo, Jazobo! There you are, you cheeky little bastard. How are you doing? It's a name I won't forget too soon. Mash F and mash WAST, same thing. Staring at the map. Yeah, no, you gotta look at the map and be mashing F, and while doing that, you can use WAST. How'd you figure that out? I don't even remember. I learnt it from Sponge. I don't know who taught him, but I know Mac knew it. Maybe Mac was the one who discovered it or was told about it. Sup, bro? You boys, an apology. Jazoba, I think you're fine, dude. I think you were fine. The only person that owes anyone an apology is Ant Mist, because that dude was genuinely being stupid. You're fine. The other guy's fine, whatever his name was. Except he shouldn't have called me a gay twink and a virgin. That was really cringe. But don't worry, bro. Jazoba, you're in the right. As long as Ant Mist, you know, has a bit of self-reflection about who he is, which I'm sure he will because, you know, the video. I meant to say some silly things, but I did find it funny. Look, the main thing was we wanted to clear the air because, like, it was so annoying how everyone's like, oh, you just kept accusing Theb of fucking teleporting. And I was like, what logic is it to teleport like this, like forward and backwards and up and down? It just wouldn't make sense. And it was really annoying that Ant Mist kept changing the subject. And it was like, bro, I need you to understand that if someone was teleporting, they wouldn't do it in a laggy way where they just teleport left and right. When's the next Crudfest? Probably soon. I might do an uncapped subathon. Do you know who is in charge of the content at Rare? Is it the creative director or lead game design? I think it's just a mixture of them all. Uncapped? Yeah, I was thinking uncapped. I don't know though. Would Crudfest Infinity be a good thing for someone? My time has come. Oh god. I need to plan when a good time for it to be, but...
I'm stuck in a tree.
Get cooked. You made 93 other accounts. Oh yeah, that is another thing, Jazoba. I can't remember if it was you that said it with MS, but when one of the guys is like to Theb, they're like, oh, that's funny, you know your name's in a Discord and you know there's thousands of people trying to get you banned. And then he's like, what? Because that was a brand new account from that day called Wi-Fi Password 93. And then the guy's like, yep, oh, it's funny that all the accounts called Wi-Fi Password are you. So the origin of Wi-Fi Password 93 is Theb and I do this thing where we brainstorm new account names for him. And he just got his new internet, as people here would already know. And he was like, what's a good name? And I couldn't think of anything good. And then he's like, I don't know, Wi-Fi Password. And then you just put 93 at the end of it. Mr. Zalus kind of, yeah, he's just stupid is my problem though. Like, I don't fuck with stupidity and he's just clearly like kind of dumb. And like, I hate that. But that was such a funny lie. It's like, oh yeah, you own all the accounts. Like, I don't even think there's any other account named Wi-Fi Password with a number, because that's a stupid username. But just the confidence when he says, oh yeah, they're all you and they're people are trying to get you banned. It's like, what are you on about? He decides the mechanics and gameplay. Oh, Mike Chapman, yeah. Peanut Master is a new Theb name. The only thing I'm mad about is Theb didn't do when Ant Miss is like, oh yeah, you come up with that name, and Theb's like, yeah, I've come up with a few bangers. I sent Theb the list of all of his usernames since I've played with him, and I told him he should flash it on the screen, but he didn't. I think he forgot to, because it was gonna be really funny, because it's just some of the names are so stupid. Like some of the ones that me and him have come up with are just straight up moronic statements. But Wi-Fi Password 93 is already banned because the new detection shit. Can't even remember what his new name is. I only played with it last night once. Oh no, I remember what it is. It's very funny. No, his current account is very funny name. Fireball Gaming is... Yeah, Fireball's Gaming was good because the first time it got banned, like months later, it was unbanned. It wasn't unbanned, but like the name was available again. What happened to Soulfarten? Soulfarten is still around. That's just Surza's ult. Then he made purely to fuck with Nessie. Took me a sec, but yeah, it works on console. Oh, nice. What is the control on console? Like, is it right bumper? Wasn't there? No, it wasn't. I played with him on stream. It was very clearly Surz. Yeah, no, Soulfarten is Surz. Theb had another one similar to Soulfarten, I'm pretty sure. Right joystick in? Oh, you have to push? Oh, okay. All right, okay. Console players, you want to head a crud launch? Pull out your map. Get in the cannon. Shoot out. Look at the map and mash right right joystick click. So R3. Oh, that's painful as shit to do with thumb. Dude, I skied. Did you see that? I don't even know what fucking island we're on. I've had so many people say hello to me on the ferry since it. I mean, look, Jazobo, if there's one thing to take from it, it's a positive, is I don't think you look like an idiot in the video. Only Ant Mist and, fuck, I keep forgetting the other guy's name. The guy in the good player. Yeah, mainly Ant Mist is the one who people will make fun of because he deserves it. Also, Baked and Tired, based. And then also, oh no, people will probably make fun of Darth Hater because that was the funniest encounter. When Theb goes, yo, this guy's name's Darth Hater, and then Darth Hater tells him to kill himself. It's like, wow, that really is Darth Hater. It's left bumper. Oh. Show my neighbors three egg in the pan. Cast an evil goblin spell to restabilize most of his sleep schedule? Maybe. Stinking Roger was... Dude, Stinging Roger was the dumbest bit. Darth Hater is a baller. No, Darth Hater is the funniest fucking username. So, Ruby's Fall. Fetches Rest. Oh, he just finished a quest. Dude, I don't know these fucking islands. I met them on Discord server, was first time playing with them. Fair enough. I mean, look, we cut most of the abuse because it was genuine. Some of the things I was saying to Aunt Miss were genuinely kind of fucked up. But, yeah. Nah, it was funny. I think, yeah, you probably come off the best out of that. And then the other guy. And then Darth Hater and then Aunt Miss. So I don't think you need to worry about it too much. And don't worry, people will forget. If anyone says something to you, tell them to DM me and I'll clear the air. Because obviously we don't want anyone to actually get harassed. We're only on the same server as you and Theban Shop as a goblin, it'd freak him out. Yeah. What's the current thing going on? It's just wasting time doing shit, hanging out, really. It's all good to find it funny? Yeah, nice, nice. All I want out of that video is that fucking Ant Mist has a fucking reality check. Did you see Theb's announcement? No, I didn't. Was that the thing about someone trying to dock someone? Bird mentioned it before, I didn't actually see it. Oh, this is not even gold. Someone doxed a guy from a Theb vid? Jesus. Did he actually dox, or did he just like... I'll have to look at it later. I'll be in a call with Theb later, probably. I'll just chat to him. Didn't just try, succeeded? Jesus Christ. Full name? What the fuck? Was it someone who knew the person, or...? Oh, that's fucked up. See, yeah, people who do shit like that need to be put against the wall and shot in Minecraft. Because that shit's just not cool. If you hadn't assault, you can be a goblin, but only for real goblins. Yeah, exactly. Genuine goblin mechanics in Sea of Thieves win. Oh. Dude, they should add a green curse. Like, not like the... Not like the Athena curse, but like a genuinely like slime green curse where I'm like a disgusting green goblin. Check DMs for the announcement. Oh, nice. Thank you, Bird.
Sludge curse.
Dude, the muck curse.
You get it from vomiting on someone.
You can only get it if you get vomited on by someone who already has it. Testing crud launch on Insider. It works. Did you see Stone Curse in the trailer? Is it a curse or is it a costume? Like, what is that? I've seen the, like, it looks like a Medusa thing because there's a Medusa figurehead in the background. But if I can have gray skin, I'm all about that. I can be a fucking alien. I can be like...
Now let's throw some crud on it!
Neon Vomit Curse. The UK Food Curse. True Crud Curse. Hey, thank you, Josebo. Gained by being slimed by a ghost curse. I mean, there is literally an achievement called, like, slime. Where is it? Yeah, you slimed him. You were sick on someone wearing ghost curse. That's literally an achievement. It unlocks an outfit, or like a piece of an outfit. Or it could be a drow-based knife ears. Well, at least no one spelled the N-word in the announcement reactions. Oh, God. Oh, wow. Jesus, yeah, I just read the announcement. Jesus Christ. Look like a curse because it had an in-game cosmetic. Oh, yeah, no, yeah, that was what... Yeah, I remember when Sponge was looking at it. They are wearing, like, normal clothes under it, so it could be a curse, but there was, like, two, wasn't there? There was, like, a... Look, if it is a curse, all I'm gonna say is Season 12, the Cement Man will arrive. Screenshot that. In Season 12, the Cement Man will appear. Fear that phrase. Be scared of that phrase. The Cement Man is coming. Can everyone... anyone who encounters someone... Can you let them know that the Cement Man is coming? The Concrete Man? Do you stream full time? Nah. I'd love to. But it would require a little bit more subs, unfortunately. Is he coming or coming? Just, he's approaching. The Cement Man... The Concrete Man is approaching. The Cement Man is on his way. Technically, you do. I mean, technically, yeah, because I just quit my job. Technically, streaming is my job, but I mean, yeah, it's not. Is that concrete information? Pinky, I'm going to fucking show you a hammer. Your only income is from Twitch for now, technically. Dude, my income at the moment is from Twitch and Fortnite. Oh, no, I'm 32. Why'd you quit? I mean, the true reason is, I live a life surrounded by fucking freeloaders who don't work jobs and, have everything handed to them. And, I've been working since I was 16 and I'm now 32. And, the idea that I've spent half my life, working to pay rent and bills and have next to nothing to show for it, yet everyone else around me doesn't have to do that and they're in the same situation as me, really pisses me off, and so I got mad and quit my job. But you know, I just bored. Wish I was 32. I wish I was 30. What? Why would you wish that? Cement Man is strong. Medusa couldn't stop him. Yeah, pushing 50, man. Sorry for asking that question. That's fine. This is right. Is this where... Dude, I don't know these fucking islands. Hang on. That's not... No, that's not that. Wait. Oh, it's there. It's there. Okay. Sounds like a middle-aged crisis to me. It might be. It might just be. Genuinely might be. I don't know. Never had an issue like this before. But, yeah. Is correct, honest work on top, yeah. It just, you know, it's not cool when I see people my age and they don't do anything and their parents pay their rent and their bills and their food and their only job is waking up at 3 p.m. to smoke weed. Wait, where to get people to do a Q in Hourglass? If you're an OCE, I believe Sponge's Discord has a looking for group thing. And he has a lot of Hourglass enthusiasts in his Discord. Being 32 and free, learning off your parents is what? No, exactly. That's what I don't like. It's like, okay, I get it if you're like in your 20s and you're doing uni or whatever. But at a certain point, I don't want to be that guy, you know, oh, I think everyone should have to work. I don't want to work. No one should have to work. But does make you feel not good watching no one around you work while you have to work. How about for not having a job and living with my parents at 19? 19, like, look, if you, you know, if you're in your 20s and stuff, I get that. It's when you're a legitimate adult and you've already been doing it for so long. Get a sugar daddy? Sure. How do you feel? No shame. 30? No, exactly. That's the thing. It's like that. And like, I can name, I'm not going to, I can name three people in my immediate, like, combination of family, friends, and sort of related people that are that age, and just, that's their life. And it's just annoying, because, you know, why should I have to do things if they don't? Is it really that bad in Australia? Is what really? Like, you mean in terms of jobs? No, it's not hard. No, 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 this is... no, this is the thing. It's not to do with... unemployability. It's to do with... being nurtured... being spoiled, basically. Being given everything you want. It's to do with... I don't know. I guess I'll say, like, parents that... they think their child is an angel, so they're like, oh, I'll pay your rent, I'll pay your bills, you can live in my house. Like, it's to do more with that. It's more to do with freeloading. It's by choice, is what I mean. It's by choice. Is property tax high in Australian rent? Yes. Buying houses and shit is impossible at the moment in Australia. Same parents give their kids trophies participating? Yeah. Overprotective? Yeah. Like, it's just a matter of, like, oh, hey... you know, oh, just in the middle of figuring something out, and then that goes on for 5 years, and then 10 years, and then 15, and it's like, oh. I think it's wrong to live with your parents as long as you pay the bills, sleep with your parents. Yeah, no, like, when I first moved to Melbourne, I moved in with my dad for a couple months before I moved in with my girlfriend at the time, and I paid him rent, because it was like, yeah, no, of course. But, you know, currently, my stepbrother lives there with him and my stepmom, and he doesn't pay rent. He doesn't have a job. He just... plays GTA 5 roleplay all day and makes really bad fucking content. In Oz, the job allowance is 14, 9 months, so if you get an early job, you'll be good from the start. Yeah, no, I've been working since I was 14 and 9 months. I got a job the day I was 14 and 9 months. I think I said 16 before, I was wrong. I literally got a job, yeah, 14 and 9 months. And then, yeah. GTA roleplay is worse than Wrecking players? Yeah, this dude, like... I've seen him do it. He's just like, bro, this is just, this is mundane. Can't find Northeast. Can't find Northeast.
Can't find Northeast.
Something happened to your dad, he'll be done for. Yeah. I mean, he'll still have his mum, who... I mean, I guess then, yeah, no, she'll probably need them to, start pitching in. Have you ever seen 5M? Like, it is literally what your stepbrother is. Yeah, no, he plays on 5M. And, you know, I love when I go, you know, visit dad and it's his birthday and we get, you know, dad wants KFC or pizza and then we get it delivered and then, you know, stepbrother comes in and then grabs his and then goes back to his room and you can hear him yelling at a video game. That's really cool. That's really fucking cool. I was in Sydney. Melbourne's alright. It's just expensive. Like, my rent at the moment just went up and it's now $977 a month, which is a lot of money, but for my house, honestly, it's not, because our house is fucking huge. It's like a 3-bedroom, 2-lounge room house. So it's pretty good. But I mean, you know, even before I quit my job, I wouldn't have been able to afford a house on my own because, like, the price is ridiculous for, like, single bedrooms. Like, if I wanted a single bedroom now, I'd be paying more than I am a month. Makes it more understandable. I'd also be pissed. Yeah, there's a lot of things. And I mean, who cares? But like, yeah. Just, I don't know, a bunch of compounding factors. And I was like, I don't need to work. Campfire, 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 campfire. I keep forgetting what I'm looking for. With all the shapeway. Campfire, campfire, campfire. WA is the cheapest state place in Oz. Yeah, but who the fuck wants to go to Western Australia, bro? Isn't Western Australia like the desert? Wait.
And housing in WA at the minute is not good.
Isn't WA the desert?
Everyone lives in Perth, and then like Albany, and then desert.
Damn. Rude. I mean, that's all I know about. I don't travel. I actually want to live in like Kentucky.
Like, you get to Kalgoorlie and then it's just infinite desert.
So it's just... Isn't Kalgoorlie like the underground town?
It's just the massive pit in the ground, the gold mine.
Oh. I grew up in a massive pit, actually. It's not on the desert, you stay on the coast. Bro, I don't like heat. Tasmania has cheap houses, yeah, but then you gotta go to Tasmania. Which, unfortunately, like, doesn't seem like much is going on there. WA is mainly mine territory. Yeah, I grew up in a town that has, like, a massive coal mine in it. And so it literally is a hole. Dude, where are these fucking campfires? I hate when I'm, like, northeast, but it's not truly northeast. Here, I bet this is it. Fuck you. Fuck you. This is not northeast. This is east. Northeast is over there. This is east. Lookout point for the west. Alright, where's that probably? West lookout point? Oh my god. Could I grab a Minecraft village? Huh. What footy team you go for? I mean, I don't really watch the footy, but... I used to go for Cats because I'm... my mum's... stepmom is related to an old coach. So that was like, I guess, just the family burden. But... Hang on, I'm fixing my headset. Why? My housemate goes for Essendon, so I just go for Essendon whenever it's on. Because, you know, he's like, oh, grand final! Lookout point far west. Car's probably alive during the Emu War. Yeah, somewhat. Oh, yeah, he's at it. Play instrument. No footy? Yeah, I don't know. I never really got into it as a kid.
Is it Ashen Guardian?
It what?
Ashen Guardian. Oh. Being annoying.
He's lying. When Bertha was okay, broke my arm over there and somehow got out of the cast. It was Rugby League Panthers, but AFL Brisbane Lions. Ah. Yeah, I've just never, like, I don't know. Footy just never really got interest in me. Did one of your presidents shit himself? Yeah, one of our prime ministers shat himself in McDonald's. Old ScoMo shat himself at Engadine Macca's. He's a fucking idiot. Three trench call northeast. Okay. Is this real northeast or fake northeast? So the cars, I genuinely don't know how I got out of it. Dude, I've never broken a bone, and now that I'm at my age, I'm like genuinely afraid to break a fucking bone. Like, if I had broken one as a kid, maybe I'd feel different, but the fact I have it now as an adult, it's like, oh. Like, that just sounds awful, the idea of my fucking bone breaking and then reforming. Ugh. Is there a monument there now? I'm pretty sure there's, like, signs and shit. You're so old. I mean, I know I'm not old, but I mean, like, most people break their bone when they're, like, a teenager or a kid. But I never broke a single one. So it's like, damn, what would happen if I broke it now? So it's the first time? Yeah, let's hope not, eh? 19, I've never broken a bone, been stung by a bee or another bug, I'm terrified of it. I've never been stung by a bee, but I have been bitten by a bull ant, and that did suck, because he bit me on the fucking big toe. I remember, I think I've told the story on stream, we were camping, and my dad and my sister were making Pop-Tarts, and they're like, oh, hey, wake up, Kyle. I was like, alright. I walk out barefoot, and I'm like, I'm ready for Pop-Tarts, yay, and then a bull ant bit me on the toe, I started crying, because I was like 9, and fucking dad and my sister laughed at me, and I went back to sleep in the tent, and I never ate Pop-Tarts. Mad as hell. First bone crud breaks is the one that kills him. Broke my collarbone at birth, haven't since. Jesus. I haven't, broken my bone, but I had a lot of stitches. I've had 25 stitches in my head. I used to just run into everything head first like a rhino when I was a kid. And, well, skin on my head is weak, but the bones are strong. Crud's head looks like a baseball. Dude, my head is misshapen when I'm fucking... Like, I can't wear hats properly. If I wear a, like a snapback, because I used to be real hard into snapbacks because I was a 21-year-old white boy, I can only wear them backwards, because if I wear them frontwards, the shape of my head makes them look too big. You have skin on your head? Barely. Fractured my arm, good thing it was my left. Ah. It's called big bone. No, it's like my head is just a misshapen lump. I think it's from just the amount of trauma I've put on it by just running into shit head first. That owns like a bee house that has 150 beehives. I remember getting stung by 13 bees in one day? What the fuck? No, I've never been fucked with by a bee. Shave your head and grow your beard out to be very large. I've tried growing my beard. It doesn't look good. Like it. My beard grows in a feral, like neck beardy, like. Hang on, I'll see if I got a picture. I'll show everyone. It's not good. Like I want to be able to have a good beard, but I think I need to dedicate literal years to it, not just like one. Where's the picture of my beard? Do I even have any? I might have deleted them because I don't like how they look. No, I don't have any. I mean, I would have them somewhere deep in my camera roll. Caught a wasp before. It was very stressful. I don't fuck with wasps. Wasps. I just don't like them. I'm looking for a beard image, but I'm not seeing any. God, my selfies are embarrassing. Jesus Christ. Ugh. Oh God, alright. Here we go. You have to helm for a bit because I'm going to be busy. Alright, so you know that gnome sound effect that Perd likes to play? Dude, I don't even want to show this. Someone give me a sub or something for this. This is embarrassing as shit, this photo. So there's the gnome sound effect that fucking Perd plays. This is him. This is that gnome. This is why I don't grow a beard. Because it looks like this. Woo! I'm squinting because I'm drunk as shit. Like, if you go to the... Yeah, look, yeah. On the bevs. Oh, God. My lips!
No sub. Only gnome.
Woo! Is Crud Keemstar? That's the thing! I have a fucking Keemstar beard when I grow it out, and I fucking hate it. Also, this shit, I get these, like, errant fucking pubic ass-looking fucking, mustache hairs. Look, I got a little hairy mole next to my eye. I got my scar from where I had to have a fucking, stent put in my eye. I'm fucked up looking, dude. Yeah, see, this is why I don't grow a beard, because there's nothing good about it. There's nothing good about my beard. Look at me furrowing my brow. Look at my hairline deteriorating. Look at this drunk ass man. Hey, it's Freddy Freaker. Look at this alcoholism ass dude. Ooh, don't look at that. All right, we're done. All right, that's the gnome reveal for everyone, okay? That's why I don't grow a fucking beard. It doesn't look good. Makes me look like a little fucking... And you gotta remember, I'm short. I'm like 5'5". Pride Magic the Gathering player? Yeah, I'm... dude, that's like a quarter of my collection. What commander do you run? Muzio. Muzio or Chatterfang? But I shave it. Oh, my beard is like black beard on Rainbow Six. Dude, see, if I had black hair, I think my beard would look cool. Because it's brown, it just looks like shit pubes. I hate it. So you sent Kelp during the incident? Yeah, he was immediately rizzed up. Guy Fieri. Mates have just started playing Magic. Dude, Time Guy, Magic fucking rules. You look like a wood elf? Yeah, because I am a fucking... I'm a small little artificer fucking dwarf. Beard isn't that bad? No, I hate it. I hate how that beard looks. It looks worse in person because it's really wiry. That's the problem, is my hair's wiry on my beard. If it was... Like, even if I cut it in, like if I get it like properly groomed, it just doesn't look good. Chatterfang is degenerate activity. I know, but see, here's the thing, Crow Goblin. Before we started playing Commander, I had just gathered all the cards. Like, I just had all of the, like, the pop-off cards for Chatterfang. And then my friend's like, let's play Commander. And I was like, yeah, sure, we'll give it a shot. And then I was like, I wonder if like, I can do anything with these squirrels. And then I looked up and Chatterfang was in, like, the top 30 decks. And I was like, oh. It was a Riz that made me do Fortnite for him. As one view chat rules again. The rule just literally says, don't be cringe. That's the only rule. Merchant crates, cannibal fruit. Hang on, sorry. I need to scroll back and find your comment. Egosi. Crud, is there any fast way to finish merchant crates off season 11? So no, they've actually made it slower. There's no good way to do it anymore. Even back in the day, before the patch, there kind of was a way, but it was more of just endlessly rotating outpost barrels. But now they just, no, you can't. Like, there's no good way, unfortunately. You've just got to raw dog it. Dude, what is this fuck? Oh, it fetches flintlock and rubis. Yeah, no, they made it worse. Muzio is sick as hell. That's a cool one. I had to look. Dude, I have a very fucking good Muzio. Okay, so Crow Goblin, the way my friends describe when we play Commander is like, I am just the villain every game. Because I have a bunch of other Commanders. I can't remember them. But Muzio and Chatterfang are my mains. And it's just like, if I'm playing, like, I mean, Crow Goblin, you've seen my Discord profile picture, right? It's fucking Metalworker. I got a Metalworker in there. Metalworker plus Muzio. Degenerate. Metalworker plus Muzio plus Neverneural's Disc plus Darksteel Forge. And all my lands are already artifacts. It's over. Indestructible artifacts, and every turn I get to spit out a bigger one. And I have infinite mana. Like, it is a degenerate fucking deck, but it's so fun. I summon Pot of Greed! Right, I was just scared to my core. Was it by the gnome? And my first legendary magic card, it was awesome. Yeah, I love magic, dude. I'm lost. We're talking about Magic the Gathering. Definitely main hero in Smash Bros. No, I don't. I actually don't like hero. I main fucking Ganondorf in Smash Bros. Or Game & Watch or Rob. Met the king of all sword lords on Twitter. This man has no fear. Holy shit. Go to Ganondorf. Ganondorf just, I don't know, something about him in Ultimate, he just became really fun to play. Game & Watch in Smash so free, yeah. So Game & Watch was like, since Melee I've been Game & Watch main. Actually it's really funny, all three of the retro reps, Game & Watch, Rob and Duck Hunt, I love all three of those and I'm actually genuinely good at them, especially Rob. Rob I am a fuckhead with. Like, me and my housemate, we've been playing Smash since like we were like fucking 14. I mean, we don't play it anymore because we got over it, but like, since Brawl, like, I've just been a Rob degenerate. It's so fun to play as him. Did you know this guy is Shiny Skeletor? Crow Goblin should be like, did you know in Canada the bones are yellow and the milk is in a bag? That's not funny. MF plays Duck Hunt, are you 50? Dude, Duck Hunt Duo is amazing. It has the most, like, psych out tech with, like, the can. Just because you can choose to pop the cans whenever you want. I like Game & Watch, Captain Falcon, and Mario. Captain Falcon's also just real fun. Like, it's just, you know, fast Ganondorf. But, I don't know, yeah, man. Duck Hunt Duo's good. Duck Hunt catches me off guard, yeah. I, forced myself to play a lot of Ridley, just because Metroid's my favorite game series. But Ridley's unfortunately not that great. Greninja was good, too. I haven't played Smash in ages. Is that a, Crud? What's up, Vermillion? I don't even know which island I'm on right now. I'm on Flintlock. South. Ridley's fun. No, Ridley is fun. He's just not that great. Like, doing the, like, sideways dash and shit. Like, that shit's fun. He just kind of sucks. No, he sucks, but Ridley's so fun. Yeah, no, exactly. Like, he's good, but, yeah. I've got a new dog at home. Haven't seen it yet. Border Collie. Oh, fuck yeah. Name it Goblin. I'm able to catch another stream, thank god. Last stream I got was like 2 months ago, god damn. Picked up Ridley and got him like 10 mil GSP. I never fucked with much online shit because my internet was so bad that like the latency was just dog shit, so I couldn't do much. Oh, I'm on Fetch's Rest. That's... See, that's the problem right there, is I was on Fetch's Rest. That's why I black screened. Picked up Ridley and got him to, like, I already read that. I'm going insane. Nice, Biscuit Muncher. Thank you. Thank you for the hearts. My line is rough, I understand, because if you have bad signal, servers come unplayable. Yeah, no, like, at the time of Smash Ultimate, like, it was impossible for me to play online. Like, my internet was so bad. Because, you know, it's fucking Switch netcode. Yeah, so I never really got to... And I think that's why I stopped playing, like, a lot, because I couldn't really do much other than play offline. Am I fucking stupid? No, I'm smart. Switch just fails miserably for online stuff. I mean, dude, the fact that Splatoon is 16 tick... Like, I like Splatoon, but 16 tick is just not it. God, I wish there was a PC version of Splatoon. What comp progress is for? I just don't want to finish it. It's mostly just because I just wanted to hang out on stream and just chat. Didn't really want to do anything important. Fuck, I hate these islands.
When we come off whatever this island I'm on, is the three skulls.
Nice.
Crud, it's been 3 hours. PV is starting to rot your brain. I think it might be time to spill some oil for Super Earth.
It's not rotting my brain. What happened to Gatorcam? Nothing. The gators are still here. I just haven't had Gatorcam on for a while. The gators have been sleeping with the gorilla cousin. They're right next to me. Wait, where's those bones? They're there. So the bones are there. Bones are their money. So are the worms. We forgot I have LA Noir for the Switch. You chose Splatoon out of all games? Respect which I... Dude, Splatoon fucking rules, dude. I love Splatoon. It just... unfortunately is held back by being on a fucking Nintendo console. Like, I don't care that it's like a fucking, you know, kids game. It's such a fun thing to play. It's 4:30 a.m. I should head to bed. See ya. See you later, brother. See ya, monkey, as well. Dude, how does LA Noir run on the Switch? I mean, LA Noir is kind of like a really old gen game, though, so... Wait, is it, like, here? No, you can't dig here. Ugh. What? What? I dug there. I swear I dug there. You're kidding. I played since release. Ah, very respectable. I got a Switch like a year ago for Smash Pokemon. I'm the biggest Pokemon nerd ever. That's unfortunate. That's unfortunate to be a big Pokemon nerd in this day and age. Used to be. Now I just have no love for Pokemon. Like, I play Pokemon Go, but I mean, I play with fucking an app where I don't have to leave the house. Just because, you know, it's dead in Australia. Yeah. That's another one where it's like, fuck, the company that owns the franchise needs to sell it. How do you have the most highest grossing franchise of all time and your games look like my ass? I was schizo for Splatoon, straight up having dreams about it. Oh, hell yeah. Dude, fucking Salmon Run. So fucking fun. Play Mario Odyssey when I got my Switch, and when I play Animal Crossing, that's my main game on it. Animal Crossing is like my second most played game on Switch. Dude, last game I remember actually genuinely playing other than Splatoon 3 on Switch was my, was Metroid Dread. I might get the PC version, wink wink, of Metroid Dread, because I fucking love that game. Very unfortunate. I want to play Legends Arceus, was pleased with it, but Scarlet was a letdown, low-key, still a very cool region, fun game experience. It's just so inexcusable how bad they make their fucking games. Like, it's crazy that, like, I know they're for kids, but it's like, bro, you remove features every game, you have such good concepts that you've used, and then you remove them. The graphical shit is whatever. Like, I don't even care about the graphics at this point. It's just like, you're just removing good mechanics. Make a big game. We could give the pictures Pokemon names. The pictures. Oh! Yeah. Hmm. I'm not buying Splat 3. I mean, at this point, there's no point in buying it. It was good for like 6 months. Looked like when playing Fortnite, my shitty laptop at 30 FPS was in 7th grade. Dude, Fortnite mobile is the funniest looking thing ever. Because I have it on my mobile for when I want to play bot lobbies. And yeah, it goofy looking. I was away with that. I was away. What is a kid's game fun to play? Gameplay Roblox. Oh, Pokemon and Splatoon. Splatoon was what I was talking about, actually. Yeah, Splatoon. My pirate's left hand is just naturally darker, like it's covered in soot for some reason. Hmm. Interesting. Yeah, no. There's a lot of games on Nintendo that just, like, I played Tears of the Kingdom on PC, and it was like wicked. And then I watched my housemate playing on the Switch, and I was like, oh, it was only good because of upscaling in high FPS and low loading times. Like, I just want Nintendo to just fucking make a good console that's up to date. I don't care about I don't care about portability. Bro's a professional ass scratcher. He's got the poopy fingies for real. Also, Pokemon Go is dead in Australia. That sucks. I really play Pokemon Go because my house is literally 20 feet from a gym and didn't have to move out of my bed. Yeah, like, it's, like, basically dead. The only place Pokemon Go is alive in Australia is directly in Sydney in New South Wales. So that's where my character is. Bunny on the way. Ooh. Ooh. Nintendo is too stuck in the past. Yeah. Like, the Switch being, portable was a cool thing, but, like, no third-party game runs good on Switch. No, barely any first-party games do, other than the select few. Then we have to stop at Flintlock to get your items.
Yeah.
Nice. My slot character is a woman. Yeah. Just spoofed a perfect location. Yeah, no, so I just, the app I use just puts me in Sydney. And that's like the busiest area in Australia. Like, it's constant. It's like those high-end places. I don't go overseas because I did it a few too many times and I got a second ban. And one more ban and it's over. Friends are into it. We live an hour or two out of New York City, so my friend went up for one day. It was super big. Oh yeah, there was the, they do like the community shit and the GoFest. Yeah, no, I just, like, do the events and shit. I also transfer my shit to Pokemon Home. I don't know why, because it's like, I'm never going to play another fucking Pokemon game on a console, but like, I don't know. I mean, my housemate uses them. Walk slowly, you'll be fine. No, but the thing is, like, if I go over to another country, I always get impatient. I want to go back to Australia. Because, like, there's different things to catch at different times of the year in different regions. Is that feeling of safekeeping? Yeah. So I'm just keeping it within Sydney. It's fine, though. Dude, this fucking glare on this thing is so funny. Where are these skulls? Ah, there they are. Send as a drive link? Yeah, that's all good. I can download it. Imagine if Crud was Curd. That'd be fucked up and evil. Dapper, do you think it'll be something that'll be worth uploading or just showing off and then making a bigger version later with a thumbnail? Because I can definitely get more clips for it, but I mean, I don't know. I mean, I haven't seen it yet. Like, should I show it on stream or should I, like, look at it and then, yeah, do something else with it first? Bigger version later? Okay. Should I show this version on stream, do you reckon? Or should I just watch it and then see where we go from there? I get so many Athenas. Doing Ash and Athenas. You just do these. Ash and Voyage of Legends. Takes like 30 minutes inefficiently. You show it on stream, maybe pop it on Twitter. Oh, okay, good idea. Very excited. because that's, you know, still a current thing though, the theme of it, I'm gonna have a lot more clips. And I don't know, I just find it really funny. So we found another exploit? Nah. The only reason I'm doing this is because I just wanted to chill and just hang out. I didn't want to do anything involved. And yeah, these are just really easy to do. I mean, I say that after I struggled to find a dig, like 100 digs. But no, there's no exploit to get Athena chests. The only real exploit at the moment that's worth doing is hero loot. And also, Zexup Pride launching. Now that's fun. Look at my health!
Damn.
I'm on like 0.1% health. There's no way you can have lower health. Should unfleet exploit? Feels like it would have been less involved. Yeah, but then I would have been in the middle of the map. And I like to do that with NZ Goblin. Yo, Skinks, how's it going, brother? Crowd launching doesn't seem to work on Xbox. Are you mashing in the right stick? It's you gotta press whatever the zoom button is, because other people have said they've gotten it working. Yeah. So you get a good ladder launch, it's still possible 90 to 100 FPS. It is, but it's going to be really shit. Like, you're not going to get that far. That's the main problem with it. You know about the exploit where you can spam raise Ash and Athena's until you get a dig at Ruby's Fall? You just get crates and trinkets without having to sail around. Why would I want just those bits? Dude, I'm on a fucking grub diet right here. What is this crater launch I'm hearing about? Oh, so there's been a discovery where you can shoot out of a cannon and change where you move. And to do it, you want to have a map of any kind. You want to cannon out, hold the map, and zoom in and out rapidly, and then you can use WAST. So, I aim straight up in the cannon. Fire, look at the map, mash F, and I'm holding S right now while mashing F, turning around, and almost landed on the ship. Yeah, crater launch. You can also... Oh, is there? Hang on, let me fix that real quick. Thank you for letting me know that, Billy Razor. I've just banned them. Yeah, so it just, you can dolphin dive with it. You can move forward, move backwards. It's left thumbstick. Oh. Hey, Crad, what's your opinion on hot tubs? I don't own one. Been Crad launching on controller. It's so much fun. Did you know about the exploit where you can spam raise Ashen Thea? I already read that, didn't I? Yeah. Now, thank you for that, Billy Razor. Because that keeps happening in servers. I saw it happening in Jay's server the other day as well. Wiesner? Do I have the ability to download this, Dapper, or do I have to request access? I might have to request access. Oh, no, I don't. Hell yeah.
Oh.
Let me download that. Cool. Is Crowd Launch FPS a minute? So no, it isn't. That's the best part about it. It's just not. And unironically, I don't know why I said unironically. Actually, no, unironically, every time you shoot out of a cannon, you might as well just do it, because it gets you further. Like... That was a shit one, but like you can dolphin dive and stuff.
Jake would have been. I need to come here. I think my thing's bugged. Unless I've got the wrong campfire.
Jake would have been targeted very frequently by NSFW bots, which has been quite sad. Yeah, he needs to set up bot detection. We think flame art ship. It seems cool. It seems pretty fucking cool. Crowd launch launches the crowd. That is true. What do you think of hot tubs? I just said I don't own one. Campfire northeast. This is northeast, right? Like...
Yeah, I'm not sure what other one there is.
Just gonna look for another campfire. Figured out I'm so EP? Yeah. The hack accounts are already in service, they don't get kicked. Yeah, that's true. But I mean, you can turn on, like... a thing that detects when people link other Discord servers and shit. Hot tubs equals bald human juice you continue to sit in? Hell yeah. I mean, I enjoy being in them. Yeah, up the hill on the west side. Yeah, there's this, but this is not northeast by any metric. Northeast campfire.
That's so stupid.
Yeah, that's northeast, all right. Northeast painted tail, three skulls. Right there. Oh, watch this, watch this, watch this. Boom! Damn it. West by southwest. I just kept slippery nesting demo you were on that step. I mean, we never would play Galleon just because it's too overpowered to be on one. It's almost 5. Good night, Crouch Out Crowd, main plank. Thank you so much for the sub. Be back with the crowd stream. Oh, yeah. See you later, brother. Make sure if you're not in the Discord that you join the Discord. Now the Flame Art ship. Oh, yeah. My only concern with it is like. Like, you know, it's like the servers are still so empty, like with only 5 ships. So like, I feel like it'd be the same. Like, I feel like you're not going to run into many people with it. It depends how fast it is. They need to make it really fast. The compass is fire. What, this one? It's not bad. There's a lot of nice compasses in this game. We've got to go to Finnock.
Now let's throw some crud on it!
Compass, 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 compass. I used to use... Where's the one I used to use? Think of the Valley of the Old Bear. Where is it? This one. I used to fuck with the rose compass. I just used it for too long, though, so I changed it. This is a really nice compass. The rose thing is cool. The barnacle compasses are nice. I really like the colors on that. I hate this. That looks like dog shit. Honestly, that's not even that bad of a compass. It's a decent compass. Dark Adventure compass is also kind of cool, but it's unfortunately Dark Adventures. Silver Blade looks like a Beyblade. Onyx compass. Admiral compass not bad because I like the colors. And, anything else good recently? I hate this. I like the idea of this, but it just looks like shit. Compass of nuanced navigation. Beyblade, Beyblade, let it rip. What's wrong with the Beyblade? No, nothing. I said it's good because it's a Beyblade. I just got the Insider one. Great. Oh, dude, I'm on, next week is Insider Funny Week for me, where I get 3 items in one day. Because today, oh, actually, I didn't even show anyone. Because I didn't even fucking equip it. Because I got it last time. Today, I got the Sapphire Blade Hurdy-Gurdy. Which means next week I get the final silver, the last 3 silver blade items. And then it's all Sapphire Blade. Here's the Valor Burning Toast. Just make the new feature in Sot. Make our compasses fight like Beyblades. Java King's loot sniper yet? Yeah. It's really fucking nice. Because it's the new team that made it. It's clean. I'm excited to see what other new shit this team adds. Like they've done. They've done nothing but bangers. Gold Leaf, new team. Cartographer, new team. Rascal Sea Dog, new team. Flaming Jackal, new team. Musketeer, new team. And Musketeer is also really fucking nice. This is the most, like, off-screen, discreet fucking sniper. Plus it's new, so, like, it's, you know, not just one that everyone's had forever. Yeah, no, the new team that makes the cosmetics are goated. If only developers didn't know what guns are. Yeah, no, they know. Well, that's my thoughts, right? They know that if you're playing a first-person game with a low fog, your weapon shouldn't take up most of your screen, but it should still look good. It looks long as fuck. It does, but, like, I mean, it's out of your way. Like, look at that. Like, it's nice. I fucks with it. I'm very excited Very excited to see what they will add next. Wink, wink, wink. Especially in terms of sniper. Wink, 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 wink. Ha 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 ha. What's Crad doing? Is burning to death is a joke. The sniper's meant to be wrong. Long? Yeah. Dude, this is the funniest because it's like, do I dare repair the mask or just wait? Let's go sell this shit. Who burnt the Athena chest? Yeah, I don't know. I think it was the volcano. What about Lobin's got a hopping shipwrecks? Couldn't get the captain thing to work. Oh, that's unfortunate, dude. I mean, it's been patched now anyway. Yeah, it is like, it is an insane unlock, like 1,000. What I wish they did for that commendation set. I wish, why can't I click build dress? There we go. I wish these were, see how they're grade 5? I wish these were 5 different commendations, like 250, 250, 250, 250, 250, and then another lot of 250, 250, 250. And there was a full equipment set. Like, imagine a cartographer entire set. That would make the journey to 1,000 a lot nicer, I think. Wow, this is our last food. Like, it sucks that it's just 1,000 and nothing else. Because the only other cartographer item is fucking this.
A couple mangoes in the crate.
Cartographer tattoo. True. I notice all the villains, other than the crossovers, have just been normal players and NPCs. Yep. Dude, we got some Ashen Chest of Legends. Stacking 11 fodded so far. Remember when I stacked 13 fodded and then I got really upset that it only got me 1.3 million? I was like, oh yeah, fodded aren't actually worth as much as I need. Tell me when you burn your treasure, it gains value. Oh yeah. Big value on the burns. Grandmarriage is your average sword blundie fodder stack with full DA cosmetics. Who the fuck would wear full DA cosmetics? Dude, this is such a god-awful fit. This sucks.
Now let's throw some crud on it!
There's cannons in the plunder pass, but not good in my opinion. Yeah. The plunder passes lately have had a lot of, like, shit almost good content. Like, this hat is fucking hilarious. Give me more to go with it. Also, thank you for the follow, Roach. Bell's dress, cool. This hull, I was using it for a bit. They honestly, I don't know why they don't just make the entirety of the premium tier also filled in. Like, just make better fucking value. Like, these cannons, I think there's a second set of cannons, isn't there? There's a top tier, top track one. Yeah, are these? Yeah, those are cartographer cannons, actually. Yeah, those are kind of fucking ugly. Let's put on the Chinese Ronin with Donnie outfit. Not now, not now. Also, that we decided that's Chinese Santa, Chinese Christmas clown is what that's called. Premium's not as good as free, yeah. Bruce is just one of those dudes who thinks Gold Curse is the best cosmetic in the game. Where's the Family Guy cannons? That is an important question. We should really take a look at Fortnite's battle passes. Yeah, no, like, it's weird that they're, like, just make it a full battle pass with both tiers just give you fucking items the entire way through, or most of the way through. Marshmallow crud? A little burnt. Flamehatter's a big bad main villain because his crimes include spawn camping, curse ball spamming, stealing all the Athenas, giving treasure to raise his infant son, because it's not about the money, it's about the malice. It's kind of funny. Realize the title is Legend of Exploits. Yeah, that's the funniest thing about this season, is that the entire season has been people doing exploits, and the title is to do with exploiting. Like, there's no way they could have known that the entire season would just be people exploiting. I love it. I love this season. There's been so many exploits, and I've shown everyone how to do them instead of gatekeeping them, and it's kept people playing the game. Gave me a lot of content, having everyone doing the C4 exploit was great, because it meant I could run into people and steal their loot. Wanderer's Secret exploit was kind of silly, though. Vault Key exploit was good for people who needed their 100 vaults. Getting 500 levels as well, obviously. Cursed Treasure exploit was great for people who wanted Hoarder of Ancient Tears commendation and title. Which is good. Is map cannon dolphin dive still doable? Yep. Just gotta do a CRUD launch. Just gotta bring up your map and tap F while using West. Jesus Christ, how much fucking loot was that? Good lord. Rolo is supposed to be this wise, kind pirate, bro. He's a communist dictator and Alliance server enthusiast. He literally tried to run the Sea of Thieves into an Alliance Spice server by offering to give away all of his Athena chests in exchange for no more PvP. Is the world record for Tall Tales speedrun yet? I think so. I'm pretty sure there's speedrun.com shit. No one cares, though. Like, there's no one who cares about speedrunning in SOT. Actually, all the villains thought it was the stupid fucking idea they ever heard. Everyone in this game has a curse. That's the entire lore of SOT, is I have a curse. Oh no. And millions from that box Wanderer's Secret thing, joined for like 10 cells and did zero work. It was insane, dude. Like, I don't need the money, but like the Reaper levels I got from it, oh. Like, there's a genuine chance I'll be close to 500 and everything by the end of the season if I actually keep playing, like, actively. Selling loot. Didn't do the Dev Voyage exploit because my genius thought it would get a special item for not partaking, so like Cheetah's Lament from TF2. Nope. I have Legendary Curse. It's the only one I care. Yeah. Legendary Curse is good. I'm glad they added it back. Like, I genuinely was mad that I didn't have it because it's such a cool curse. Let's see what my levels are. Getting two old distinctions of Reaper in like 3 days is crazy. It is. So my only concern is getting my Athena levels up. Like, cause Reaper I'm at like 340. But Athena's only 280. So I need to do a lot more Athena work like this. But this doesn't even get you that many levels, unfortunately. It's like one level per voyage. I'm just gonna fucking look at it. 283 to 290. So I got 7 levels in like 4 hours. Like, obviously that's not the best. I think if I was doing the hero loot exploit, it would be faster. But yeah, so 290, 334. I want to try to get these both to 500 before the season's over, but we only have like 5 weeks, so I don't know if that's possible. And what that means is you invite me when you go to sell loot or lower your hourglass tricks. Thank you, Goose, for helping out.
No worries, mate.
Alright, let's watch this video that Dapper made. Oh, and we gotta watch Sozo's edits. So let's watch the Sozo videos first. Sozo.
Fairly nice and chill stream today. Lots of good banter and a very chill guest appearance. Looking forward to the CRUDcraft playthrough.
Oh yeah.
Although I would very much like to talk to you about the CRUDcraft to server. I'm sure we can find something that can work and be fun for a bunch of you.
Yeah, man.
Woo!
Alright, so let's have a look at... Wait, is this the edit you wanted me to watch, Sozo? Oh no, you wanted me to watch the edit. This is the edit. You didn't want me to watch that video.
No, actually. Something like...
Most recent two?
Don't be too hard on yourself. Yeah. Yeah. Good shit. Good shit. Hell yeah. No worries, Sozo. Fuck yeah. Don't be too hard on yourself, chat. That's it.
Holy shit, it's a J edit. Oh, it's me. Uh-oh. Jesus, dude. Oh, you gotta not.
Next time.
How much?
Secret.
Why?
Just guess.
$600?
Jail.
Swear to God, is that more loud noises? Holy shit.
That's it. I'm about to get racist mode.
Kelp! Oh, he's gripping it. Holy shit. Dude, big if I can grip an apple like no one else. That reminds me, I got a KFC. That's literally me. The Mog King. The Jelka, the Guna. Oh my god. Oh god. Oh no. I bet this isn't really the end. How did I guess? This is schizophrenic.
Fat.
Look at you, Peter.
Oh no.
Grades have been steadily
decreasing. You spelled truly wrong.
Late for class. You always appear exhausted.
You say you can't sleep. Heartbreak.
Oh, the content theft? Oh no. How?
Probably cause the Brig was here and they don't, and that probably overwrite our voyage.
But I feel like that shouldn't. Good English.
Your homecoming?
Okay, good. So it went from 14 subs to 216, based. Oh, the real end, based. Very nice, Ozo. Good shit. Alright, now we gotta watch the edit that Dapper has made for me. Which we will make into a bigger video. So let's have a look.
Oh, there's a people ziplining,
Where?
Yes, where?
Over here.
Are they ready for the train?
105 on one. Fuck, I'm bad.
Bro, the Chainiac just knocked him with the wings!
Yes.
Yes. Nice.
I got Chainiac one. Going in. What's the Chainiac? He's a maniac with that chain. Oh shit!
I got fucking knocked. Behind this rock still.
I'm 3 HP.
Rezzle?
Yeah.
Oh, it's John Wick! But it's the Chainiac.
Yeah.
John Wick was not a fucking match good for shit. The Chainiac! Hell yeah. Chainiac stunting on him. Dude, this is the best clip of all time. Look at this shit. Show me a better clip than this in Fortnite history. You won't find one.
Oh, you fucking idiot. Caught you off guard. Caught you off guard.
I wish there was, like, in-game voice so I can start saying stuff.
I know.
I'd be like, the Chainiac is coming, brother!
Oh, up here.
Fuck,
grab the Chainiac. They're all Chainiacs.
Where are they?
Up top, top floor.
How do I get up there?
Come around to me, come around to me.
Watch this.
Ready?
Insane Chainiac moment incoming.
Chainiac going in, brother! Where is
room?
Insane Chainiac moment coming in.
Go!
The Chainiac's in here, brother!
Yes!
Dude!
Boom, boom, boom.
With the Chainiac, dude, I'm in
destroyed. Oh shit, Aphrodite heals.
Dude, I'm the fucking oh, they're all dead.
They're on top.
Oh, Chainiac going in.
Dude, look at this insane Chainiac gameplay. Watch this. Boom, off with the roof.
Oh, Chainiac is in, brother!
Nice.
One down. I can't even see I'm moving so fucking fast with the chain.
Good shit. One more. Outside. Good shit!
Dude, I don't even know what the fuck just happened.
Aphrodite, join in. Yeah. Oops, someone's here.
Solo Chainiac. I'm just a maniac with that chain, you gotta admit. Just hear Sir's coughing.
It's gonna be funny.
That's Omni Man's ass.
A strong whip! It's a boo-boo baba!
Oh yeah.
Bro was not the match for the Chainiac.
Dude, John Wick sucks.
Chainiac operates in mysterious ways. Nope. Oh. Another victim of the Chainiac approaches. Where are you? There you are. I see you.
These were not bot lobbies, by the way, everyone.
Get over here! Oh! Fuck yes.
That's the Chainiac. You can't beat the Chainiac. You think you can beat the Chainiac? You're a fucking idiot. That's sick, thank you, Dapper. I'm gonna get a shitload more Chainiac clips, and we're gonna make a funny fucking video with that. Oh shit, alright, who's live? Cedral slash... What is this fucking title? I would that, the smoke? Yeah, man. What is C-Man? I don't like that title. Who else is on? Sunder, Banshee, Sponge... Who's on? Oh yeah, I gotta raid Copria. I've never rated this guy. Dude, this dude's a fucking Chad. You know, everyone loves Brian Underpaid. This is a dude who plays with Brian Underpaid. Alright. I'm gonna get KFC. Thanks everyone for hanging out. I hope it was a fun crud stream for you. It was fun for me. There'll be another one tomorrow. And then the next day. And then the next day. Anyway. I hit this dude with the old crud raid. And yeah. Dude's beard is on his head. He has the most lunar haircut I've ever seen. This man is a half moon. It's amazing. Check out art. All right. What do we got? That goes hard. That's JoJo, right? That's JoJo's art. Hammerhead creature. All right. We got... Oh, shit. Oh, yeah, you're doing JoJo art. That's fucking cool. Isn't it Good Friday? I don't give a shit. Skull drawing. Okay. We gotta give you the art roll. There we go. Dude, Alex with their fucking Halo art is fucking cool. There's some talented fucking crudheads. Look at this shit. This is amazing. I can't do this shit. Look at that. This is cool. More of mine deeper in? Yeah. People gotta stop flooding art with non-art related shit. This stuff, I love these. Consume the Burger did a really nice looking dagger art. Yeah, Davy Jones. Old, what did I call him? Darren Johns. Alright. Oh, there it is. I love that. Anyway, we're raiding this guy. Crud raid this guy. Bye-bye. Plug.